Welcome to some very high quality collegiate CSGO action. We got IEPY CSGO Varsity versus DePaul Varsity, both 2-0 in the Swiss group stage, we'll call it, of FACEIT Collegiate Spring 2023. Jack, do you know how many weeks there are?
Yeah, it should be like 7, 8.
That's pretty believable, I think, because they want to finish this up probably around May. Yeah, so winning this means, like, you know, you're already halfway to,
there's eight,
close to halfway to a perfect record on the season with 64 teams. There, 64 teams makes it impossible for there to be more than like one or two undefeated teams, right? By the end of the season, IEPY looking to be one of those, because 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, that's six rounds. So yeah, it'll be impossible to have exclusively undefeated teams at the end of this regular season. So it'll be interesting to see how long IEPY survives. It's kind of funny, if you look at IEPY's roster on FACEIT, their rank is like 7. Like, their average rank is 7. But I think they represent a lot more danger than a level 7 average would.
Would entail.
Yeah, for sure. Moving on, we can get to the... I think this is the first time that I've streamed a varsity game this season. So I'll just quickly go over what is the one player change from last season to this season. And there's kind of two ways to interpret that. Let me see if my Chrome browser is going to... let me fix this real fast. Hopefully. Yep, okay. So, if... I don't think I streamed a fall game for IEPY. If I did, then the five that was playing then was minus Yeti from the previous season plus CAC or RAFs. And that season, I think, almost exclusively got screwed because of scheduling. They would have made playoffs, and I think they had to forfeit at least two games in the regular season. I think that maybe even they just forfeited one, and that was enough for them not to make playoffs in CSL in the fall, because the divisions were so small that, like, just going undefeated would make it such that, like, you just weren't making playoffs, unless you went through a last chance qualifier that was, like, was a scheduling nightmare in and of itself. So IEPY did not make playoffs in CSL fall. Since then, they brought on EXT to the roster, and I think they're pretty happy with that move. I think this team has potential to go pretty far in FACEIT Collegiate, and I don't know if they'll be undefeated by the end of the season, but they've definitely got a shot to be seated high enough to make top 8 in the playoffs, at least, in my opinion.
For sure.
Moving on to the match veto is going to start in 10 seconds. This will be a best of 3. So each team's going to get a ban, and then each team's going to pick, and then each team's got a ban, and we'll play with what's left over. I would assume that IEPY's initial ban would be something... I mean, is it just Inferno?
It's Inferno.
Is it just Inferno? Yeah. And as far as first picks go, I think that they, to be honest with you, would be fine with picking a lot of different maps. Like, I even wouldn't be surprised with Mirage pick with this 5.
You, with this 5, you're definitely, I would say you're not seeing a nuke pick. I think you're fair. You're seeing a Vertigo, Ancient, Mirage. I'd probably put Mirage up as, like, they're probably their top pick, to be honest with you.
Well, it's just a map that I know all of them are at the very least comfortable on, and they haven't really practiced with this 5 a whole lot. I think once the ESEA season ends and they get into, like, those 4-0, 5-0 Swiss stages and then they get the playoffs, there's a lot of money on the line. They'll probably start practicing on a decent routine, but that's only speculation.
Yeah, I just could be seeing Nuke. I don't. If you see Nuke, they're not picking it. Oh, obviously Anubis.
I don't think they'll pick Anubis, but I think they'll be very happy with their opponent picking it or being on map 3, to be honest. Because, I mean,
the recent success, and Shraylock and Gumboot knowing things, I could see him picking it. They definitely are comfortable with it. But really, they're really the one map that, like, will probably get picked on a lot that they just don't like is Overpass.
Yeah.
I just see them banning Inferno more than Overpass.
I can honestly see them banning Nuke before Overpass with this 5. But yeah, that's just because you just don't have the practice, and Nuke is a map that, like, you kind of need to know what your teammates are doing.
You know, yeah.
Like, I like the CT side is complicated, in my opinion, but only because you just need to know what your teammates are doing. Because, like, the decisions themselves, I think, aren't too complicated, but, like, if you both make the same decision, then it's, like, instantly a disaster in some cases, so.
Yeah, so, like, really, Nuke, Inferno, and Overpass are the three maps that, like,
while we're waiting, I'm glad you brought up that Anubis was, like, so, like, key to them, because IDPY is only in this 2-0 bracket because they came back and stole their opponent's Anubis map pick, and then went on to lose their own. So in a world where they don't come back and win this Anubis game right here, they are just not in this 2-0 bracket at all. I think if Wrath was on this team, I think they would have definitely, unless, the thing with, like, banning in these kind of environments is, I'm sure Straylock probably went back and looked at DePaul's map pool, which I'll do right now. Their map pool in these cases heavily informs how you ban yourself. So, like, that's maybe why last game they were able to float Mirage until map 3, which they knew Wrath was a very good player on and very comfortable on. They were able to float it because they knew Kennesaw would allow it to go to map 3. But this time around, it looks like DePaul has played Mirage, Inferno, Anubis, Inferno, Inferno, Mirage. So, Anders got a Vertigo here. It's a very similar map pool, it looks like. Even an Ancient thrown in here and an Overpass. So, no Nuke. Here's a Nuke, but it's May of last year.
That's May of last year. So
the most recent maps are Mirage, Inferno, Anubis.
Yeah, and you're seeing Vertigo Inferno.
Is somewhat recent. It.
Yeah, so definitely seeing Inferno ban. They're not going to pick Mirage, obviously.
I'm a little bit worried that DePaul is not here. Because the sub-in period took the entire 3 minutes, and now they're not banning servers. Like, that would be really funny.
This could be possible.
Although I'm pretty sure they. You have to schedule for Monday. So
I mean, they did say they were scheduling issues. Right, IPY did.
I mean, it could be stall strats. But
yeah. Admin will restart servers if they need to.
Yeah, yeah. But, I mean, I think you literally... I don't know if you get the full 3 minutes for map vetoes. Is it 30 seconds or 3 minutes for map vetoes? You've done them, right?
Yeah, it's... I think it's the full.
It's the full 3 minutes for each map?
If it's full, right... Or if it's, like, 2 minutes, yeah. Something like that. It felt long.
Okay. They might milk this whole thing. I mean, that's... But you have four, it's like 12 minutes plus you've already got six. I mean, you could stall up to like 20 minutes with this. But I mean, in most situations, I think IAPY is going to be generally willing to just like wait if needed, especially if it's like a 30 minute wait. But we'll see. This was 2-0. So it looks like they've 2-0'd both of their opponents very comfortably up until this point. Yeah, 2-0 over Grand Canyon. Not even close, really. Breezy dropping 26 and 12 on map 1. No clear carry in this series. Yeah, still no. Vito's there. I hate that you can't like open a new window on these match pages, which is moderately irritating in my opinion. Villanova gets curb stomped. This was a best of one though. I wonder if they just did two best of ones rather than. Yeah, that's what happened. I mean, it looks like DePaul has a pretty balanced effort, at least in blowouts. It could be different when it's close matches. But Breezy and Anime Profile Pick, Def, are leading the way in those four matches. I'm getting DMs from the King. Okay, they're calling an admin to put in their sub. They forgot to sub or they misinputted the sub, so... Okay, that's been done, so they're actually banning now. So Inferno and Nuke are the first two bans. DePaul definitely was the Nuke ban, I think.
Yep.
And IPO is the Inferno ban.
So, and I think that Nuke ban is just that also DePaul just not liking Nuke.
I don't believe that fully. I mean, Nuke is a map that people will ban if they don't want to play.
So I think, if I had to guess, I think maybe an Anubis pick. They're going to float Mirage. I think out of IPOI. And then DePaul picks Mirage. And then map three is probably going to be Vertigo or Ancient.
If I were IEPUI, I would be picking into Ancient here. Because DePaul has no history on Ancient, and you know how to play the map. If you're comfortable on it. But we're not going to know the picks until... Like, they're clearly thinking over this pick. It's been 30 seconds.
No, I think this is... Is this the map pick or is this the ban?
Here's the perspective from IEPUI. We're not going to see the picks until the...
We're not going to see the picks.
This is the second pick.
Okay.
From IEPUI's perspective, they know that their opponents are both comfortable on Mirage and Anubis. They've seen them play that, and the only other map that they've shown is Inferno. So, like, you don't need to pick into either of those maps. I mean, they saw what DePaul picked, I'm pretty sure, when they were picking that pick.
Alright, IEPUI just picked. Now DePaul's picking.
Yeah, they banned out Anubis, so IEPUI did not pick Anubis.
Okay.
And now IEPUI is going to ban out, probably Overpass.
Yep.
So that it probably was an Ancient or a Vertigo pick. Yeah, it was a Vertigo pick.
Mirage,
so
Vertigo,
DePaul with the Mirage pick, IEPUI with the Vertigo, and then Ancient's left over.
Okay.
So we're going to see two of the worst maps in Counter-Strike be played. All right, hopefully this IP trick still works. I believe this is raw.
Mm.
So, plus one there.
Giving it to me raw.
Yeah.
I see you.
Yeah, okay, it was raw. I got some Sprecher root beer.
Well, classic. Ooh, Mr. Mutton staying up late tonight. The root beer.
I cracked open a cold one.
Mmm. The closest you ever get to real beer.
It's probably true.
100% true. Unless you get forced to drink at a wedding. Like, at one of your brother's weddings.
I mean, I guess, but I think any wedding that's gonna happen is probably gonna be, like a Christian wedding. Like, most of my family, like, if they're gonna drink, it's wine. Like... I've never seen beer at a family gathering on the nice side of the family.
Really?
Like it's always either like wine or nothing.
Wow.
Alright, this is where my transition immediately goes well and I don't have to be working. Smile. Okay, then cool. We're gonna get an Austin Wintery music kit for game 1.
Is Andy's screen messed up for you? Or is it just mine?
Male BBL CMX. I think it's two. Just Andy, like, you swapped other people, it's the same. It's, like, fine. Everyone seems okay to me.
Here, can you look? Yeah, can you just look at this?
Do you think to it, or?
I'll tab really quick.
I am.
Alright, ready?
Oh, I see. Well, I'm glad you're not the streamer. That's crazy.
It's just him too. Big guy.
So, I gotta say, in pure anime dynamics with 3 out of 5 going to DePaul, I think DePaul has the anime advantage right now for sure. There's always time for IEPUI to make that up with profile pick switches in between maps, but as of right now, having the Bunny Girl group tag plus an anime girl profile picture, I think goes beyond EXT's male anime picture for sure. I think Def kind of has an anime adjacent picture too, so that helps the case, at least, you know, half a pick's worth. Nightmare scenario is I have to pause the server and rejoin. Oh my god, Breezy is insane from the forbidden angle. I like Chris's group tag.
Male BBL?
No, the Chris on their team. I don't understand why you made that mistake. Chris 0506.
Life gaming?
Life gaming, yeah. You can tell they're a university from Chicago because their ping is 997.
That Chicago server going crazy.
Is DePaul within like the actual city limits of Chicago, or is it like Chicago land?
I think it's like within.
That's what I thought it was downtown Chicago. And I by think downtown, it is, it's obviously downtown Chicago. Is massive.
Right.
Well, yeah, I definitely think it's in. Yeah.
So I mean, it's two urban universities, we'll say. You could chalk up a rivalry here. Well, who is Cyclone? I can't unmute people. If there might be a command, but I don't know it.
Oh.
Is it SAC? It's SAC, okay.
Sackers?
It's S4K, but I'm assuming he wants it to be pronounced SAC, I don't know.
It might be just S4K.
SAC is kind of fun to say, though.
Alright, we'll call him SAC then. Or we knife? What?
No, my guess is, like, the first two games were just such freebies for them that it's, like, they just didn't even think about this stuff. So, like, even if their opponents weren't doing it right, they just went with it, right? I mean, if you're a level 10 stack going into, like, Villanova and, what was it, Grand Canyon or something? Like, you're just going with it, you're headshotting them, the game is over, and you move on with your life. But this game's actually worth their effort, probably. I was 100% correct. I was 100% correct with what they did. Wow. All right, well, this is live, and CT side pistol round. Sherlock's going to buy up two flashbangs with the CT side. This is likely going to at least send one over mid early, or just save both for B retake. So it's going to be the latter, and it's going to be a B rush, so those flashes are definitely going to be deployed in that way. There's no util on the T side at all. It's going to be a contact play. EXT's boost here should be good against this, hypothetically. Because you're really not going to expect him to be up here this fast.
You got a good day here.
Yeah, and here's the contact. EXT in position to frag. Going to let the first two pass. Now taking some shots, and it's a little bit labored, but he does get one. Chris raging in voice chat.
Chris yelled abs.
EXT somehow is the last alive in this round. It's actually insane, but he is queued up for a 1v4. Both players kind of just, like, figure out where he is. Those steps will reveal his location, and they are ready for this. EXT is convinced there's one market, but he's on empty pillar. He has a kit. This flashbang is, I don't think it's going to be good enough. SAC just out peeking. And SAC is able to hit the headshot through the flashbang, gets his crosshair where it needs to be at the last second. A nice try from EXT and a pretty chaotic and fun round to watch, but it does go the way of DePaul.
Yeah, it was a good bait and switch setup. Took a little bit longer to activate in the way. I
mean, those are hard shots to hit.
Sure.
Those are very hard shots to hit.
And it scared Chris to the point of him yelling.
It was their Chris that yelled.
Yeah, their Chris, yeah. He yelled abs. I heard it.
I guess I'm just going to have to say CMX. Like,
yeah, CMX.
Early A utility. I mean, this is definitely it's just an A pop. It's a little bit late. SAC is out 20 minutes ahead of all of his team, but the flashes are so good it doesn't matter. And Def just runs in and cleans up what was left. Gumboot has a pretty fast rotation on the stairs here, but it's almost going to mean nothing. That fall is not hurt by anyone, so shots will be, and DePaul cleans that up. Five alive. Four of them took a lot of damage, though.
Yep. Just a simple A-pop. We'll probably see something fast here again. Two max 10s, three Galils. CTs will be on low util. Three of them without head armor. These max 10s could...
Yeah, that's a good... I mean, literally every gun the T-side has right now does not one-shot headshot unless there's no head armor.
Yeah.
So...
And... There's three without, so these could do work. We might get another fast A pop again. And it looks like it.
Yeah. I mean, the flashes were the best part of that last A execute. The spacing was sus. The spacing is much better this time. Straylock under Palisade was not going to get flashed. The Molly's a bit late. Straylock getting the first kill gets traded. Rotation's not coming in. Big Daddy 8 hoping to find something through the smoke. Gumboot is just taking fight CT and winning them. There's no CT smoke on this play. Now Breezy goes down to Gumboot to a 4k for Gumboot, and that shows the importance of a CT smoke.
Yep.
Oh no, Gumboot! He swapped to the Glalie!
Okay.
Why did he do that?
Quick A pop there, and they were obviously trying to get into Fast CT, but the their goal was obviously to get into Fast CT, and they just didn't have the time. The CT's delayed long enough and got the kills that prevented that from happening. Allowed Gumboot to just take free fights.
Straylock getting one there is literally just his job. Gumboot went pretty much, like, Gumboot went insane there, but the lack of a CT smoke is a bit puzzling on a gun round execution. Oh,
now
great utility from Straylock.
Now we're gonna see the a default here. Dedede gets one.
Cyclone there for the trade, but the smoke is just too good at protecting Big Daddy A. I don't know if he'll be ready for
you
this.
You mean sack? You mean sack?
I do mean sack, but I'm gonna say Cyclone probably a million times. Big Daddy A 3 HP gets away with that. That smoke did not land how he wanted it to, but he's glad he got away with his life.
CMX got a big nade off Cat before he got away. Not getting spotted. Yeah. The nade does some damage. Lurk smoke con. Interesting.
It missed. I don't think that's what he wanted.
Yeah,
I
don't think that's what he wanted.
Smoke. There is a nice lurk out Tetris here. I think it's just a spot out of Tasman. Sherlock knocked down to 42 HP. That nade
could kill.
Yeah, it will. Yeah. Wow, nice shot. Or nice throw, I should say. Sack finishes off his job from earlier. Gumboot gets one. Wow, that was a nice shot from Gumboot. And that might be the difference in the round. Even though he was immediately traded, that kill on the top Palace Balcony player completely shuts down the momentum of that A execute. CMX trading players with Gumboot. Sack. 17 HP, reloading, extravagant, rotating in from CT spawn. This is so tense. The bomb is down on A. EXT waiting patiently and will shoot Sack right in the back. Round goes to IEPY 2-2, and DePaul onto a save.
Yeah, there's a lot of just good utility there from IEPY, and I don't know how Gumboot got that. Was able to even get one there on the double swing with the Galil. But he was able to get one on his shot. I don't know if you're able to see it. And then EXT keeping his composure, not going through the murder hole.
Yeah.
He was thinking about it too for a second. I think he might have got told not to, but either way, he played it well.
That's exactly how he played that. You just give the bomb plant and win the 1v1.
Yep.
DePaul definitely looking to do
here.
A lot of eggs. They missed their top con smoke. And Big Eddie A punishing for it. The flash is good, but not good enough. This is going to be a cleanup for Skywars. Five alive. No damage taken. Not a single point of damage taken.
So far here, DePaul is showing that they are a team that does not practice much. I say that because back when I solo queued Mythic Gold, these were the exact strategies that like Pugs would do. It's contact B, fast A, ecos are palace pops, default is three out mid. They're not showing any like really team strats. These are legit just Pug strategies. Obviously it's Mirage, but like there's nothing that hasn't been done.
Yeah.
That like that's like shows them that they're like a real like team like type of thing. They're doing the just normal Pug default strategies, and it looks like it's gonna continue.
Gumboot up Cat finds a pick on a death.
Yep. Breezy lurks A. Yeah, this is just a Pug.
I mean, it looks like there was definitely some kind of read here from IEPY to stack three towards the B bomb site. As of right now, that read is kind of like, you know, it's not good or bad because the default's still going on. Man. So many
Breezy's out and Sherlock does not let Breezy get out there.
Yeah, that's a super key kill because the lurk just stops. Mid fights are still ongoing. Chris got knocked down to half HP from a nade thrown by Big Daddy in a window. Looks like Yiff is trying to make a bit of a play into apps, but that flashbang brutalizes him. Chris holding the angle that Big Daddy is about to peek, and will punish it. Now Gumboot. Pretty much the only mid player, only mid contingency on Catwalk. That Molly will slow down. Yiff goes down. And
bombs
apps.
And spawn.
Yeah.
This is just a Pug 10 stack team. There's nothing here. Like that's just.
I mean, you can identify the exact pressure point on this round that would have turned it towards DePaul, and that is Gumboot not winning the fight, Cat. And
Straylock not winning the fight.
Yep. And like. If you are, you know, hitting your shots and you're clearing off angles and you're, you know, your opponent misses a shot, you can flick to the off angle and kill him. That's good enough to win games. But if your opponents are hitting shots, then you're left, you know, 2v4 and you just have to save. So another point to support your earlier argument about there being Pug strats. On the DePaul A executes, they were throwing one fast smoke like by the trash can that was presumably, I think, a jungle or a stair smoke. and no one else was throwing a fast variant of their smokes. Like, they were actually lining them up, which is why their spacing out ramp has been so, like, kind of suspect, I'll say.
Yeah.
On those plays, so. I mean, this is not a good buy. This is also just not a good economic situation. I think you force around these rifles, which they're kind of doing. But the problem is, like, you lose this round and you're on another save. Because you saved, like, nothing. Once again, leaning two towards the B-bomb site early. I'm good on his tail. When I spring through the early mid-window smoke, not going to find anything. But the AA going to swing with his AUG, finds one, but quickly traded. Will they take that space? They will. Fast in the con. Gumbu finds one, not the second, but Strelok trades from top ticket, which then gets traded itself. Two versus two develops, one mid, one A, and the bomb is still T-spawn again.
Oh my god. So again, the bomb is in spawn, which I guess in this situation kind of favors, like, in a sense, T's, because CTs are going to be confused, but it's not T's. It could get caught out.
It can favor T's if the CTs get ambitious and, like,
if they get ambitious, yeah. But not in this situation.
I mean, this is where, if you're a T side, you start to rationalize the B play, and that's what's happening. Sack taking the bomb into apartments. Yeah. And I don't think Chris understands the gap that was created by him not getting to that murder hole quickly, because CMX is on the B bomb site, and I'm just not sure that DePaul is betting on that. And EXT is in a very good spot the second he hears a footstep to punish this play, if there is one. CMX is up into apartments. Sack is clearing these angles and wins the fight. That's super big, because EXT is now making footsteps. He's going to get shot in the back himself, most likely. Oh, wow, he turns and wins that fight.
Picks up the Galil. I don't know what IPY is and picking up Galils are, but...
So much util to make this clutch happen as well. But I don't think he's going to be ready for this push into market. Nope. Off angle. Completely shuts him down. Sack with the apartment's entry onto CMX wins the round for DePaul.
Yeah. CMX got ambitious and honestly probably had the favorable, like, first peek and just got headshotted. Leaving their bomb and spawn, though, and it pays off in the end, so. 4-3. Full buy here.
That trading sequence on the A-bomb light was actually a beautiful Counter-Strike. Pretty basic mid-take here. Big Daddy A's top con spot that he kept farming kills from just got mollied, so he's forced just to play top con. A lot of map control early. Sack this time taking up the A lurk rather than Breezy, so I'm wondering if they're just playing spawns or if they're just kind of feeling what they want to play, mixing it up. EXT goes down on an apps push, but is traded from CMX. Deploys the Molotov, and looks like we're going to see our first window boost of the game. Gumboot is holding for it, but gets headshot instantly. Big Daddy A now in a very tough spot. We'll find the first. Straylock is playing all the way back deep CT spawn, though. He was worried about that mid-window push. Big Daddy just narrowly avoids a headshot to his right. Now needs to worry about his left, but isn't going to be able to turn in time. Now Straylock, he is the linchpin for this round being winnable or not. The smoke might be good enough for one-way, but the teaser are watching for it. Insta-HS once again from the call side, and CMX goes down on the cat rotation.
Yep, just because they are defaulting essentially pug strategy type defaults doesn't mean they can't hit their shots, and for the most part now DePaul is starting to get a little bit of momentum. That's two in a row. They're starting to hit their shots. They're in good positions to trade.
Yeah, that's super key.
They're in a lot of good positions and getting a lot of good trades here, which a 1v1 trade definitely favors T sides. So
no A lurk this time from the T side. How aggressive will the CTs push us? It is instead an absolute flood out middle. They are taking space very quickly. EXT, the B player, doesn't die, so they won't be able to hit that tell, but I don't think that these pistols are going to be good enough to shut down this play. EXT has a decent lurk here. The Molly misses, but they might have saw the gun barrel. They definitely saw him that time. Yeah, gonna go down. CMX, the male BBL, lurking into window with a flank behind him. This is likely going to be the lead for DePaul on their map pick. And IPY's economy, it will return to a viable position, but I still don't think they'll be able to get an op. Nice shot from CMX. Probably gonna get shot in the back here. Axe is gonna get shot in the front.
Yep. Simple, go out mid, take fights, eco round type thing. And now we'll get back into the buy here. Big Daddy A only on a FAMAS though.
Yeah. Preferred the util over the gun, which is he made the opposite decision two rounds ago. He bought up AUG, Smoke Molotov, didn't have a full utility belt. I don't think he died for it, but making the opposite decision this round. Same mid default that we've seen, this top con molly. CMX is pushed into mid, so is Gumboot. It is pure chaos. Chris is flicking around like crazy, goes down. CMX has to whip out the USP. Can't hit a shot that time. Big Daddy now just going through the smoke. I think it was holding underpass for him beforehand. And Sack with the bomb gets away with swapping weapons and the bomb into the corners. Big Daddy has to be absolutely livid. And if he didn't have a FAMAS and instead had an A4, it was probably the opposite result. EXT has been spotted in market. They still are taking the bomb into B. That jump will give away his position, presumably for Yip. That shot definitely will, though. And despite DePaul's players all being hurt, they're going to walk away with a 3-alive gun round victory.
Yep. I try with the aggro mid play. If Big Daddy gets that kill, that round probably could go differently because he'd have bomb down.
Not able to
get the FAMAS kill. IPY forced a save, and this could easily be 7-4 after a strong start from IPY. DePaul's kind of coming into this T side.
Yeah, I mean, whiffing that top mid kill, that you know the bomb is there, is with the FAMAS, is just so tilting because it's like, well, if I just didn't have a boss. Ooh, nice shot from CMAX. But if he pushes, he's going to die. Yeah. Greeds for the AK. Not a horrible play because of how much solo A lurking you've seen in this game. But gets punished for it. All four players for the T side grouped up around A. Gumboot is pushed to absolute. I mean, there's a chance that a stack could actually materialize itself. But now the T side's running away at the same time that the CTs are running away from their B stack itself. This is actually tragic for the Jaguars. Breezy gonna go down for free to Big Daddy A. But the bomb is now going to be planted for free, and that's gonna be almost certainly the round. Bench, the rare two bench post plant. Gonna go for this. Takes a lot of space, but the only one to get a frag there is EXT. 7-4 in favor of the blue demons. Is this the first offense seen out of IUPUI? I think it is.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, that's something that you look back, like, that's something where you lose the CT half, you look back at it macro, and you're like, why did we never just, like, say for an off? Because it's, like, so key. But, like, in the moment, you're always like, well, I need to buy one, you buy. Really scaling.
Yeah, I'm trying to get fast
into Connie. Big Daddy should hear that. Like, it's not calmed or not heard. Sure, like, a headshot. Big Daddy gets a trade and gets another one, but they're still running out A. The AUG good for two, but not good for three. This midlurk could throw a wrench in Gumboot's rotation. Especially because he's AWPing. Breezy gonna take down CMX on the rotation. Gumboot has just been heard and spotted. One bullet to the head, and that's going to be almost certainly an eighth for DePaul, unless Extravagant can make a extravagant. Gonna be shut down before I can even finish the sentence. 8-4, DePaul leads, and IUPUI thrown onto another save.
Yeah, I don't know if there's a lack of hearing or communication going on, but he just ran up con and got essentially a free kill. Even though Big Daddy A trades two, it made space for the A players to get out, and they head to A ramp and traded.
Yeah, that's an A anchor's worst nightmare, is you playing like an off angle you've never done. You just run the off angle one time to try to catch out an A ramp player, and then you get shot in the side of the head connector because your mid players don't have that. It's actually the A player's worst nightmare. T-side looks like they kind of just running around this round. But I think the end goal here is B. Nice solo kill with a 5-7 for Strelok. He's able to salvage an AK. But I think the key player on all of this is going to be EXT. If he can't get a kill, he's going to need to at least stall. Gumboot walking up catwalk, not aware of the danger that immediately faces him into apartments, and here it comes. The Molly actually misses it. One of the go van. Gumboot hits a nice 1D onto a flying player out of apartments. There's two apartments to find. 2 versus 5. EXT with a deke spam gets him on the second shot. Chris able to find 2, and he's going to need 5 to win this round for his team, though. Has a Molotov and a flash. What an insane... Oh, Strelok actually finds that call to EXT. Chris now in a 1 versus 2, but double swings into 2 players, or swings into a double swing. And IQ finally stopped the bleeding.
Strelok, don't kill a teammate challenge. I feel like he's done that in a lot of his league matches lately. But regardless, it was a great eco round. It was a good push from him to get the initial kill. Kind of forced him into a B play earlier than they probably DePaul wanted. There was 2 there. Blake was able to find 1. EXT was able to find 1. And in the end, it was a 5v2 and 5v1 cleanup. So good eco round, much needed to stop the DePaul momentum. Now we'll see what happens here. Anyone's changed it up. And it looks like it's going to be another mid-fight play.
2 underpass for IDPY.
And he's up. He's running. Def is running up again.
Does Def even hear this? I don't think he's heard this, but it's like a fast cat play. This is such a weird round. They're scaling up cats so fast. There are 3 apartments for the Jaguars. Still not able to find 1, but quickly traded. And here come the other 2. Will the T-side be ready for this? They're definitely not, because they were planning for it. Gumboot trying to find something through the smoke, but unsuccessful thus far. C-Max crouching under lead. Biggity finds a lurk kill from Cat, but is traded. And Gumboot finds the kill onto Chris to close it out. Chaotic, but apparently the Jaguars are thriving in that.
Very chaotic round. I legit want to know if like everyone's headphones just aren't working. I feel like there's been so many instances of just like obvious you hear people running out, either not being calmed or people just not being aware enough. Like the extra guy apps, the guy planning wasn't even aware of. There was I don't know how quickly Big Daddy called together. They were running up Cat from his calm position. Regardless, weird round pays off, and it looks like we're gonna end with a fast B.
They threw the B-Rush smokes from spawn here.
Yep, get right,
this
get left.
This was supposed to be an apps take for the CT side, but they're going to be met with an apps rush. EXT, full blind, CMX full blind below him, and it is a travesty on the A-bomb side for the Jaguars in a round where they can't even save. Oh, let's go. Aug theory. 5 bullets in this A1S. They try to make some space here. Patch the smoke. Is gonna get out window, but getting pieced by 2 different players. Strelok finds a consolation kill, but that's all. It will be 9-6. DePaul leads at the half on their own map pick. Not a back-breaking scoreline, but definitely not one that you want to enter the T side with. Your IPY.
Seeing in any person's fear. I have a Valorant game. Mate. Interesting talks.
Okay, T side pistol starts. Strelok has a full belt of utility. The bomb being sent towards the other bomb site. This might be an underpass to A play, and this is a jungle smoke from Strelok. Looks like that is going to be what's going to happen. While the CTs have a stack on B, they only have 1 on the A bomb site. Def's gonna spot off this underpass run, is running for his own life simultaneously. Smoke's now flying in for jungle. Sack from Cat just completely destroys that part of the push. BJ just narrowly escapes that USP shot and the second. But here comes Yif through the jungle smoke fighting. It's pure chaos once again. Strelok finds a kill from triple box. 1 on stairs, 1 on CT. CT gets pierced. Strelok can't finish him off. Finally does. 2 versus 3 in favor of the Jaguars. Strelok's mouse just completely spazzed out. Oh, Chris, he sees that. He can't hit the shot, though. Zach making the late round decision to flank around CT, but gets shot himself by a flank. Chris fights 2 quick headshots, and now CMX will hit the clutch shot. He only had 1 shot to make that happen, and he will take it. Pistol round goes to IEPY, and that is a good start to what could be a comeback.
That was an insane pistol round. Sag seemingly blew it up by getting 2 kills. Cat but yet IEPOI was able to get a 5v3 by winning all the fights on site, forcing DP to save here. And we're gonna see a nade stack. Wonder where we'll take five grenades, either top mid or a ramp. See, and it's gonna be a ramp.
It's gonna be a ramp. Will EX not use T's on pass? This is gonna be a wasted nade stack.
Count the money wasted.
1500. Those nade stacks will just make the call that there's probably no one be. Yeah. Jaguars are very confident in this. Very quickly scaling out. Rotations now just coming in through market. That's definitely been heard. This is going to be a cleanup. Some stat padding.
No mag 10 though on the T's by the way. All rifles. Well. You're not making much money for this one.
I mean, on the flip side, all five are going to survive, it looks like, so.
Yeah.
That's money made in itself.
Nope.
Big Daddy A goes down hunting for eco frags. That's poetic, really.
No one. Oh, I thought no one was going to pick up the AK for a second.
Right. Paul likely to buy up here. Yep. So, super key rounds here, mainly for the Paul side, but if no bomb plant for both teams. Looks like Gumboots lining up. Mid-smoke. Yeah, gonna be thrown by Strelok. Midwindow actually decides against it, so I guess they're gonna let things play out early mid. Def does the Midwindow jump to Khan on with the grenade. Very aggressive positioning. Absolutely. From Yiff. Backs out of it though. This is actually the slowest default I've ever seen IEPOI run. Quick kill underpass. Def trying to trade will get punished. And goes down. A great nade from Big Daddy A. Yiff finds two with an M4A1 spray, but gets traded by Big Daddy A once again on a 3K. Could ace this round. He's looking ambitious to do it. Breezy just narrowly missed the timing on Sherlock walking up a ramp. That could be a big factor in this round. Breezy so close up connector. He's trying to phase the smoke on Big Daddy A. Big Daddy A gets... He's just so ready for that, and now looking for the ace. Will not find it. A little bit greedy there, and now a 1v2. Definitely winnable for Chris, as the bomb is down top mid, and I think he got a glimpse of it there.
No, I don't think he did. Probably reswung here window.
Wow. I mean, it certainly would have shown up on his mini-map. So, I'm shocked. He's worried a little bit about a flank here, and I guess it makes sense. They really didn't have much map control.
I mean, IPOI is convinced he's CT at the moment.
C-Max goes down, bomb down! 26 seconds, he's gonna run Khan here. Or at least that's what Straylock thinks. Now he's heard him run away. 19 seconds.
Clearing jungle. No, he hasn't.
Chris goes. Oh. Great shot from Straylock. Wow.
What a look.
Big Daddy A gets four kills to open up that round, yet it comes down to a 1v1.
Yeah, Big Daddy A was doing the most there. Picks up the opening three kill or opening two kills, gets the trade frag, picks up the lurking Breezy, and yeah, almost the round lost as Chris almost 1v2s. But Straylock aware, realizes he's Khan, gets the headshot. Another save here, we'll have a deco.
Nothing too aggressive from either teams. We've yet to really see a fast mid take out of the IEPOI side. It's all kind of just been a delayed one. Cruising into ladder room could be interesting if IEPOI decides to do that, but with that mid window kill, I would assume this is going to be a quick A split. C-Max doesn't flash on accident. This is kind of a weird off angle from the CT on top stairs, but I don't think it's going to matter. Cyclone from default finds one, but is quickly traded, and C-Max. And a disperse of Yiff to close out the round. IEPOI take the lead, 10-9.
Yep, just like CT side, off to a hot start. Continue if they can continue this momentum. This is the round right here. We could see a potential op on Chris, yep. And we will. So op cannon is out. They have full util. CT side, we'll see. And it looks like it's gonna be a fast day. I already can tell it's gonna be a fast day from IEPOI. So we'll see what happens here. As they have the fast A util coming up.
Yep. So we're gonna have one con and one default. It's gonna be playing the classic off angle, but it is flashed. He is so blind. He's not ready for this default push, and Nico's down. The scaling is perfect from the Jaguars thus far. Death through the smoke finds one, but is not gonna be able to stop the side push. Now, Breezy, he runs through the CT's Molotov, trying to find a kill. He will random Gumboot. And now it just becomes a deathmatch server, leading the CTs. The flashbang is not going to be good for Breezy. But they, what? He gets both kills, and Straylock finds the last onto death. A crazy flick from Big Daddy A mid-spray.
Were you on Breezy's view, too?
Yeah, I was.
Yeah, just expecting the trade, and then, yeah, fast day from IPY. DePaul, you know, was not ready for it. Got the kill on the site with the good flashbangs as the anchor decided to play up, picked the wrong round to play an off angle on site, and that's gonna put the CTs on another half buy here.
Looks like we'll finally see a quick mid scale from the IUPY side. Yep, Breezy and Def doubled up con, pushed off the close angle. Oh yeah, great shot onto DXT there. CMX playing a devious off angle back underpass.
What the hell is this, man?
He's like trying to throw the op off the map and he is successful. Wait, there's a T spawn flank. Big J is not ready for this at all. Chris, a little bit timid about it, and he is so timid that he doesn't get the kill. He runs through the molly, finds Big Daddy A's back still. And now they're forced into a B play, seemingly. Which they miss a Molotov, and now Sherlock just has to jump out. The flashes are good, but will the frags be? Yeah, but the Deagle goes down. It's pure chaos. Gumboot finds another. CMX scaling out, and Gumboot finds one as well. What looked like it would be so bad for the Jaguars has now calmed down, and Sack top fragging for DePaul, but needs to once again clutch up. Yes, yeah, CMX is back turned, hits the shot. He only needs one body shot under Gumboot to win this round. But he won't find it. The aim punch is good enough for the Jaguars to win that, up 12-9 now on a 6-round spree to start the second half.
I don't know what the lack of communication was on the IPO side in that 2v1. I don't know what was going on with Chris, man, with his MP9. DePaul probably should have broken this streak and have won that round, but yet somehow they do not. And even with knowing that they're going B, they still are unable to get the kills. I guess it's partially due to the fact they're on pistols, but IPY gonna be happy that they won the round. Doesn't matter how they did it. We got a fast mid play? No, it's gone. I was running up mid.
Yeah, he's done double cast though. He's just thrown that nade top mid and then strafed in the connector.
Got the cat boost though. On Breezy.
This is a pretty standard late mid default where you send just two underpass, two top mid, you pinch once the initial CT utility is gone. Now, one thing that is very good typically against these slow walk defaults are off angles like this boost, but that flashbang is enough to scare Breezy off of it, so. T side will start to converge into middle. Straylock on share scares Breezy into ladder. JA trying to make advances in the connector gets knocked down, untradeable. Def gets away. And now there's just so many angles that the T's have to worry about as they're trying to scale into either connector or catwalk that taking mid becomes a difficult task. And that smoke is too deep to cover anyone who's trying to, you know, come out ladder. So this could get really ugly really fast for the IUPY side. And indeed, Jellock going to go down from the stairs. Gumboot could get shot in the back at any time, but is not going to. Scaling on the stairs does find one, but is traded. 2v3 now. EXT and CMX both find a kill of their own. Now Yiff in a very winnable 1v2. But CMX on this headshot angle is not going to be an easy find, and it won't happen. CMX and EXT with a 2v, is that a 2v4 or 2v3? Either way, I keep on to 13 rounds. Still yet to lose the T-side round here. DePaul has to be kicking themselves right now. Their own map pick is falling away so rapidly. I gotta say, CMX on the CT side was bottom fragging, I think, at like 8 kills. And now he's already on to 21 on this T side. He has had a great start to this half. Looks like it's gonna be either a fast B or a B contact here for the T side. It'll be interesting to see how they react to the smoke. You don't usually see a smoke this deep this early. If they're able he's gonna be so close to being flashed if they throw
we'll
one.
See if EXT can see him. We'll see if EXT sees him. Oh, and he does.
Amazing headshots. Now it's all under Breezy to stop this, but that flash is brilliant.
Oh, but EXT doesn't pull clear. And he gets two from it. Chris is just out with a scout. He gets a tag.
It's a disaster.
He tags two people. 1v3, but...
Maybe he's holding this, and he heard it. He took a step before he ran through. Everything is working for the T side of IUPUI right now. It feels like, and even in situations where it starts to get scrappy or it starts to get, you know, 50-50, that they're just hitting the headshots.
No, they are winning every 50-50 battle, it seems like. That deep smoke was a good idea, I guess, in theory, but Yif didn't realize there was two shooters phasing that smoke.
Yeah.
And he met one of them.
Early mid push from Yif. That flashbang is going to give away their intent. CMX is ready, but does not have a shot. Gumboot dinked up in the process, but is able to escape with his life. Now, Big Daddy is sprinting underpass. Def hits a nice FAMAS headshot there.
Yif just dinks Gumboot in the way back. A stray light kills him. Just a stray bullet hits his head. That's a tilter.
I think this is finally going to be the round where we see DePaul win a CT round. CT smoke comes in. Chris gonna tag down Gumboot, who was already earlier headshot. Now Sherlock at 1v4. Not able to find one. So DePaul on the board. And honestly, with a decent economy to boot. Winning even just one more round with 3 or 4 alive will give you a decent amount of momentum, especially seeing as the T side, if they buy up into an AWP here, might be broke with a one round loss. They will opt into it. Very key round here for the CTs. If they can shut IUPUI out of even a bomb plant here, this is where your comeback could start. An interesting touch here is Strelok is throwing a mid-window smoke that lands on this Molly in a way. Oh, he missed it this round. I was just about to brag on Strelok's smoke, and then he missed it. I don't think it'll be punished because the CT shows no intention of peeking. Gumboot just got off the angle, though. He's not going to inspire any kind of swing out of death. That Molly will force him out, though. 4 mid for IUPUI, 1 a lurk. And what is... He's not aware of... Oh, the timing is crazy! But Yif will find it. 5v4 for the CT side. And Def's going to make it a 5v3. So finally, we're seeing some life out of Blue Demons. Very likely to move on to the 11 rounds here. CMAX going to see a shoulder. Left eye peak disadvantage is really showing itself there. And Breezy, I don't really know what that smoke was for. Bit of a panic smoke, and now CMX scaling so quick into window. Is Def gonna realize? This is, as a CT, you can start to feel uncomfortable in these situations. With Yif and Palace, though, I think DePaul is gonna be more than inclined to give this a bomb site and play for retake. Chris, I think he's been jump spotting to an extent to apps, and he's seen nothing. 37 seconds left. This T's have to make a decision here. I'm a little bit surprised by Yif's decision to flank mid here because you just don't have the time to actually make this happen and you're giving away your A-ramp advantage. Now, if they're going to go B from catwalk, it won't matter, which looks like it's likely. And Chris thought it was going to be A, so he just rotates off the bomb site. Now, he needs to get into a decent spot before they scale into him. The flashbangs from Market will help so much. CMX runs out of bullets and Chris peeks him in that time frame. Gumboot 1v4 to 8 OZ. Nothing to be found, and IUPUI are going to have to save.
Yep. That was a nice pause considering the situation by IUPUI. They had the situation they wanted. If CMX, I don't know, I guess I reloaded at any point, he picks up those two kills all day. He had one guy out in the open for free, jumping in the market, and then he probably would have had the swing trade. But that, I honestly think that lag of bullets cost them.
I think the T-spawn push out of Yif was like bad in multiple ways. One, he's never making that mid-flank in time. And two, he fooled his team to rotate off the B-bomb site because he thought A was clear. And that almost was the cause of the lost round. Anyway, it's going to be fast palace pop. And Cyclone has a smoke in his hand, so this is going to be an entry for the IUPUI Jaguars for free. Never mind, he lived. I don't know how that happened. CMX scaling will take him down. CT is now rotating in. Starting to clean up the mess. But the trades are still going the way of IUPUI. Now Def's in a 1v2. Finds the one on the CMX. He heard Big Daddy reload that MAC-10. Only 5 bullets, though. He reloads. Big Daddy hears that. He's scaling out so fast. Another smoke in hand moment. And DePaul loses against an
Palace Pop.
I don't. The reload, the smoke. I'll tell you what, Lost. Shraylock glocks someone with head armor, three taps him from sandwich on a guy jungle. He three taps glocks someone. And I'm pretty sure that kill just. That kill essentially just gave the round. I don't know how he's three glocking someone. But
I just can't believe he's throwing a smoke line up for a ramp that late into the round. I feel like I'm going to opt once again towards Palace, this time with guns. It's going to be a lot more measured. C-Max, I saw say that. One not dies, now EXT's turn. I think they're just desperate to try to take some map control back. CT smoke being thrown from Big Daddy A. Strelak is able to find Def, making a bit of a green pick on top stairs. Fights going on both top and bottom. Petra Cyclone has lurked himself out to the forbidden angle and dies. I'm shocked. Now Big Daddy A trying to make this round a favor. The flash was decent, but not good enough. Big Daddy A goes down, and now Strelak with 8 HP goes down. How is this a story of three different fights? So, IEPY, despite their, I'd say, lucky round to get out Palace and win, they're now back onto the same save that they were before. I think Big Daddy has honestly bought maybe a bit too far into this.
He just bought AK armor. He had 5k, thought he could hero AK. How much money do they get?
He'll probably have enough for armor AK if he gets a headshot and no utility. So it's going to be another B contact. This worked last time, mainly because there was an aggressive player into apps. That was Yif. Yif not at the B bomb site this time.
Yif is lower. Pass.
Chris, he's going to see them on the next jump spot, and that's going to be a call. Here comes the flashes. He's anti. Flash himself. That might blind his teammate. Did not. Breezy finds one. And finds a second. Chris finding one of his own. Big idiot with the hero AK. Finds a kill. Really good for his econ. Finds two! The B bomb site is open. There's still one player left out. That's Def.
Oh, Big Daddy is like insane. Flick shot is 2v2.
Finally, we go down. Cyclone. The tap from CMX might bait out the app's flank. CMX was ready for it, but not on the right angle.
Wow. What was that shot?
Bro, I swapped to Chris's POV, or was it I swapped to whoever ran out's POV. I didn't see Andy's flick. I saw it from his opponent's point of view, and it looked even crazier, probably.
Oh my god, I was on Andy's view. Holy.
Alright, big right. Round's here for IQI if they don't get a bomb.
Huge fight, round.
Yeah. Those three kills made it very easy for Andy to buy up into this. But if he had not gotten those three kills, he would not have been able to even buy head armor, I think. This is much like the defaults we saw start to happen by APY. Underpass centric, late mid takes. Very patient.
Although I mean, B-Daddy like is close. Yeah.
Go contact B again. They liked what they saw last round. They just didn't. They just, you know, it's like, okay, well, we lost it with pistols. We'll win it this time. Yep, good. Yep, Strela goes down. Will they still commit? It looks like they are still going to commit. Breezy, next point of contact. This is such a weird spot to pause in. CMX finds a lurk kill in mid. Gumboot now swinging! Well, the AWP misses his shot! Will clean up on EXT, but he doesn't have any bullets. The AWP nerf coming into play here. Reloading, there is some scaling out van, but the market rotations are here. Chris trying to go for the under van wallbang. That nade is going to soften up EXT a bit. CMX still on a T-spawn lurk. He might just be saving at this point. For next round, seeing as how bad their econ is going to be. EXT getting lurked up on by Chris, who's looking for his third in the round. Hits the shot, and now CMX has to decide whether he wants to try to do econ damage to the CTs, which is actually valuable in this case, or just save the gun himself. For 26 seconds, I mean, what can you even do? At this point, they're ready for anything. Yeah. Just gonna hear those footsteps. Hits the headshots. Does that convince him to go in? You're getting very dangerously close to just going down after time. And that'll be it. So, DePaul in the best position they could possibly be, really. to take this thing to overtime. This is their own map pick.
This is going to be fast A. This is going to be fast A.
Yeah.
From IPY.
So, I mean, Sack is the solo A player typically. He's got plenty of util to stop this. And there's actually going to be two people running out of spawn this round. Yif is going to join him at A. So the CTs are very well positioned to stop this, but they're still freaking throwing utility. They're going to be able to clean this up, it looks like, though. Two early kills from the CT side. Kills through the smoke only means so much. EXT 1 versus 4 goes down. I cannot believe they almost just caught out with utility again. Overtime.
Overtime. Get an extra CS for map 1. Free Counter-Strike? Anyone order free Counter-Strike?
IEPLY is definitely not going to be happy with this, though. They were up. It doesn't show me now that we're in overtime. I feel like they were up at least 15 to 12. Kumbu going to buy into the AWP. This is, I think, 12.5k start money, so... Especially at the T side, not a very crippling purchase. Has a good spawn. No interest from the CT side in fighting mid window. I think Connector is where we'll see these early fights start. Def is up on a one-way smoke on the top box that'll catch on a catwalk player, but there is currently no one scaling up catwalk. Instead, it's Big Daddy lurking and grubbing in this Connector smoke. He's so close to them. The flashbang comes in, and the fight starts. Big Daddy gets the first and turns and gets Def. These flick shots from Big Daddy, that's like the third one this game. That is absolutely crazy. He's getting tagged up from the cat player. Gumboot trades that. Now the Palace Lurk activates, goes down, can't hit the shots, and CT player actually doubles up for his troubles, but he needs to hit all five to win this round for his team. As a CT in overtime, this is where you start to consider the money, and the bomb is going B, so... I have no idea how this is going to play out. It's actually backing out and just going back A at this point. Big Daddy has been so key in these T-side rounds.
Feels Big like... Daddy has been so crisp in this game. Like, he really just...
1 HP. 30 bombs, officially.
It's been a wrecking crew with insane flicks. This is his first game, by the way. First game of the season for him.
True. Those Connector players must absolutely be livid at what just happened to them. Like, that setup is supposed to counter that. And they still got beat. Maybe another slow default out of the Jaguars. No aggression from the CT side, except for in Palace, where XT just shot down that push. So, an early 5 versus 4 advantage for the T side. And these CTs stretched so thin here. I think they're going to have to just cheat everyone off the B-bomb site, except for maybe an AWP rotator and market. Smokes go in top con. Here comes the map control mid-tick. Looks like we're going to end A here, bomb A ramp. But without an aggressive cat player, this is going to be hard to stop the Connector split. Inching up. Breezy is right here. Jungle player in Def finds a kill, but is traded from the Palace Lurk, and the CT guy goes down as well. So now it's just Breezy from Catwalk. Tags up a couple players, but not good enough to kill anyone. If you're Chris here, you need to save. You save this all day. He's not saving, I guess. I don't think anyone can really buy him. Breezy finds two. He's gonna go down. Sherlock just shot him through the headshot hole in Firebox.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. That was from Firebox.
Yeah, IPY, you know, after choking OT, seemed to have regathered themselves. No reason. Well, I won't say anything about that, but...
Oh, look at these spawns,
last round
dude.
And a half here.
It's like a starfish.
Looking like a fake fast A into a B contact, B rush.
Yeah, It's actually a really good call because Chris, who has to save with 5-7, is on B. Wait, they missed their jungle smoke. EXT gets one and goes down. There are okay. They rotated off the B bomb site. The fake has worked perfectly. The fake has
they
worked
have a
perfectly.
Free B bomb site.
Xenex probably goes down here for. What the heck is going on? Breezy takes his knife out. As he hears the bomb being planted B, he's stuck in a T spawn fight. He wins it, but how long did that take him? Both market angles smoked off. And Cat was smoked off. So much utility was left for this T side. But Chris, he's taken an AWP. He's found a kill with it. Gumboot goes down. 4 versus 2. The T side needs to just stall for a little bit longer. Def looking at all the wrong angles and goes down. Big Daddy A shooting players in the back. And Straylock triples up in the post plant. Another unlikely T side round goes the way of IUPUI.
I was shocked that, like, DePaul even had, like, a legit chance in that. But Straylock and Big Daddy A shut it down with a. The Big Daddy A was playing Ring Around the Rosie. And Sherlock was popping heads when they were, couldn't find them. And now, one round away from stealing their opponent's map pick of Mirage.
Yeah, I mean, it's worth noting that just the last series, IEPY took their opponent's map pick in overtime and then lost their own map pick of Vertigo. So, it's very possible to see a repeat. Early mid take from DePaul. We saw this a lot. They were scaling very quickly. Close connector. Definitely planning on ace splitting here. TMX from Catwalk should have some decent punish angles if he's ready to peek these con players, but. We're gonna smoke bottom con. That should stall any T side aggression. That. Yep, CMX is on the perfect angle to punish that jump up. If you walk up con, or sorry, catwalk enough, you can see the jump up and just catch him out in that moment. He's lurking up connector here. I wonder if this is a bit of an overextension. He's gonna get punished for it. And Charlotte goes down as A anchor. They're gonna scale up onto this A bomb site. He's in the Daddy A with the AUG in jungle. He finds the first. I think he maybe didn't see that guy sandwich. The AWP. VXT. Okay, he's gonna rotate back B. Yeah, I said if he wasn't careful, he might walk into that. T side being given the bomb site to plant if they want it. BDA, wow, BDA just punishes that push from sack into jungle. This plant has to be for default, I'm pretty sure. That smoke is just not gonna. Oh, smoke is so sus. It's gonna work out. Breezy finds the pick out of the CT player, and now he's watching top stairs. Both CTs trying to push through the jungle area. Breezy finds another kill, trying to keep his team in it, and Big Daddy goes down as well. Clutches yeah. That out. I gotta wonder if that Gumboot push into connector was really the trigger.
Definitely started it. Sherlock getting picked, and then on the op putting in work. EXT just having nades out as he swings wide. A lot of just misplays there. That was more of an IPOI loss than a DePaul win. So
bomb's gonna be.
Def picked up the AUG for T side. I'm kind of curious how that would go. Big Daddy gets killed in the cross.
Yeah, and they're gonna scoop up the bomb. This might just be a late B play after all of this, but the double catwalk play gonna be boosting up CMX, taking fights on share. That nade should. Oh, that's just the firebomb. And he's gonna escape with his life. Oh my, he almost burned. Despite the early A loss, Straylock is pushed up into a pretty decent spot ramp. So this is where you could start to gamble away from the A bomb site. However, bomb is headed with another three players towards this ramp area. Sherlock gonna catch the bomb with the nade in his hand. Bomb goes down as smoke. So key. The T side is gonna have to jump up. Simplifies the angle so much for the T side to come clear this. Gumboot from CT punishes Yef, who thought he was clear to make that play. Breezy with the off goes down, misses the shot, gets traded. But after all of this, the T side is now at a man disadvantage. Looking to reset. There's 50 seconds left. Looks like they're just going to end up going Palace. That's smoke. We'll cover that angle for them. CMX into apartments means that there's no need for a rotation to be at all. Instead, it's just going to be on Gumboot and EXT to hold this Palace play.
any inkling about mid control is wasted for this. Right now, Gumboot just gets walked out on EXT looking mid. Now he's gonna wait for CMX to double up on this retake. That Molly gonna force him back. T-side looking poised to get onto overtime 2 points. Both of these rounds looked so good for IEPY until they weren't. But it's not over yet. EXT hopping out of stairs. Both T-side players are grouped up around this default box. But they can't know that. EXT getting caught on the jump down to sandwich. Now CMX with all to do. Finds the first. He knows the last is Firebox. He doesn't hit the shot. Def keeping his team at 18 to 17. One round away from double overtime.
Again, like, it's just a round that IEPY loses and DePaul doesn't win. Or, like they win, but, like, doesn't feel like they win. I don't know what communication was there, why EXT was looking mid.
I mean, when his teammate... I can understand why EXT is looking mid. It's just the position from Gumboot simultaneously is what costs them it.
If you have... But if your teammate's default right, you just hold his palace, and, like, if you die, he can trade that. Because he's in a... Like, you just have to take that risk, I feel like. Either way... It's another round for DePaul. And now, TT economy is not looking good. Gumboot's only on an MP9, and... Double 30 bomb from Chris, or CMX and BDDA, trying to will their team on their opponent's map pick.
Mid smoke comes in. Very, very passive setup from IEPY. Literally just watching the pushes from every choke point at this point. Incredibly passive. Big Daddy A on an off-angle stairs, but he is on left eye peak disadvantage and is close to the angle, so this could be a pretty hard fight to win. Jungle Smoke comes in, A split being signaled, but not being communicated until Jeff runs in and finds BDA, but is traded from Straylock and CT spawn. Breezy scoped up on that exact spot now, though. Bomb scaling out onto the bomb site, and CMX goes down on rotation catwalk. So now it is. This is now. We've talked about how it's IEPY trying to lose. Now it's DePaul's to lose, especially now as Breezy has shut down Straylock. Gumboot and EXT with it, the pieces to clean up. After seemingly sweeping overtime, they've completely collapsed. And this is an almost impossible retake to win. Breezy gonna shut down the first peak. EXT shut down again. 18-18, yeah. Double overtime. I think if you asked IEPY in this moment whether they threw, they would even say yes.
Yeah, that. They're going to have to regroup because that had to be a tilting overtime to lose three in a row like that for them. So we'll see how they come back here on this round. But I could tell that definitely was a tilter.
I honestly cannot believe they won the first two rounds. And by they, I mean DePaul. I can't believe it.
No, I'm right there with you. That round was DePaul's for sure. But the other two were IEPY's a loss and...
I mean, what we've seen, especially in this overtime period, is just DePaul. This is the first time we've seen them not basically run out mid and try to take that close con space immediately. And it's the first time I think we've seen IEPY throw the anti-Molotov, or the anti-smoke Molotov, and there's no punish because there's no one out mid. Now, Yif threw, I think he threw this Lurk Smoke himself, he threw this Lurk Smoke for Tetris, and it's definitely keeping the attention of the IEPY players on A. Bomb is really not in a position to make any quick plays off of any information that Yif would get, but just now is when the mid default is starting. Bomb still located outside of T apartments. So whatever picks get had here either way, the bomb is not in a position to come out. Breezy's, I think he's just tagged Chris to the wall maybe. Gonna run away. Any position where you see an AWP pushed up into B apartments is when you start to think that they're going B, but it's just not the case at this moment. Def lurking into connector. This is exactly how we picked Big Daddy last round. Straylock is probably able to find Def. Maybe overthinking the situation a bit much there. Three towards the A bomb site for IEPY, and that's where this bomb is headed. Chris is jumping up with the AWP. That is a puzzling play, but it was only 28 seconds, so I can kind of get it. Time desperation. Now, Sack running in, trades either way, BKDA goes down, 2v2 developing all of a sudden, and this is definitely going to be put into another A-bomb site post-plant. We've seen IEPY fumble these on 3 straight occasions now. Will it be a 4th? Aid's not going to be good enough. Smokes and flashes on both players.
How will they be used? Smoking the bomb here is not very useful. Both players are within sight. Breezy showing a bit too much of his left side. But the time is ticking so far now. Under Palace is not cleared, but Flix 2. Breezy stuck on default, getting wrapped, goes down. And IEPY, they pull a retake on the A-bomb side back.
Oof, that was a 5v3, and I thought IEPY was going to do it again. They were going to lose a round, they should win, but... Breezy was doing a lot of work with that op. The trades were there for the pause. They walked out A. Even with the three people there, they were able to put that in a manageable 2v2. A good retake by CMX and Zanga EXT, though. Just won their fights. And then CT round awarded to the IPY side.
First CT round won by either team in overtime. Okay, the early AWP pick goes the way of the Jaguars this time. In overtime one, Chris was able to find a pick onto BJA as he crossed. This time, Gumboot finds the pick onto Breezy. Went for that play. BJA gets caught out. Does tag down Yif quite low, but isn't able to find a kill. So, 4v4. Once again, bomb not really in any kind of activatable position. Mid under the control of the T side, but CT is able to punish any... overextension on catwalk. It looks like Gumboot might be in that exact spot, but gets overswung and dinked. Def in the ladder room. CMX in a position to punish. Will Def be ready? Nope. CMX easy kill. Gonna back up. 4v3 now. Sack lurked up quite a bit. Gets an insta HS on TXT. Cannot find CMX though. Now on a double kill. Bomb still down T side apps. 53 seconds left. So much rides. Particularly for DePaul on this round. Two CT players are quite low. The decision to end at either bomb site here is going to be a tough one to make, but with 30 seconds left, I think a B site take here is inevitable. And it looks like the CTs agree. They are headed to a three stack on this B bomb site where the T side is walking.
Unlosable if you're IEPY. You have the read.
Yep, gonna go down here to CMX.
And indeed.
Just a bit labored. Alright, IEPY once again start out the half. Every single half they've played, they've started out incredibly well and then fumbled. Few sides by here is still pretty good, but Breezy only has a smoke due to the frequent op purchases. I think it's the first time we've seen no one run towards the A bomb side on the default for the call in overtime. It'll be a quick scaling out mid with four players, and Breezy gonna go underpass. Looking to maybe just make this a deathmatch server. Yeah, that's gonna be a pretty good nade. No, it isn't. Top pot smoke thrown. Map control taken. I think DePaul's trying to figure out where they want to end here. As they've got lurks on both sides of the map. PDA Breezy, I think he walks just a little bit farther than he wanted to. Def gonna get a double kill with a gun and with utility. Yef running in, trying to trade the spot. PDA with a 5-7 finds one, but is traded. Now Chris, he got a Cadian profile picture. Can he replicate a Cadian A-site Mirage clutch? If he sticks this bomb plan, I'd say it's unlikely. CMX, he's ready for the stick. Will he be ready for the second? Oh, I think Chris wanted to stick that, but got off too early. 34 seconds now.
He did.
Now he's just trying to find a kill desperately. With the HT so close left, though, yep, that's not an easy angle to clear. I feel like sweep the first half. Can they find even a single round in a second?
There we go. Another great half from IEPY. They just need one. I don't expect a fast day here, but we will see it probably next round. I just know Sherlock is anti-rush these first rounds here, so I don't see it happening. I see a mid-default here on the IEPY side, but I feel like they'll do fast day if this doesn't work out.
want to see the two mid.
Three
two
mid?
Under.
Is it aggro mid play? Oh, no. I think he tried to go for the cat jump. He tried to go for the cat jump and missed it. Okay. There was an aggro type play going for mid.
Def's actually ready for this underpass crawl.
Oh, he got away.
Last second.
He's still holding it, though.
There's no one top mid to punish him. Like, literally just no one there. That jump is going to give away his position. C-Max is going to be perfectly ready for this crosshair placement. That flash is so good, though. He gets both players. 5 versus 3. Now IEPY just bailing out into an A execute. With 4 players leaning towards this A bomb site, it seems unthinkable that DePaul could lose this round. Flashbang coming out. EXC looking out. An opportunity on the CT guy, but it's a hard shot. Strelok goes down. This is looking like a 5 alive for the CT side. Strelok gets 1. That's it. Flashbacks from the first half now popping into IEPY's mind.
Yeah, it was a great pop flash, but let's see if this is the fast A here. Let's see if I've called it.
CMX looking towards mid.
Yeah, if he's looking towards mid, then no.
Oh.
No. Okay.
But
heavy mid
don't
default.
Have they don't have an A lurk. It might be fast B. Or B contact. It's gonna be. Huh.
It's a B lean. Top mid smoke. Did Yif not see Shreylock?
Yeah, they're gonna be here. And there's only one person on this bomb site, and it's just Chris offing. Now, there's really not going to be a flashbang for the Jaguars to take this peek. He gets 1.5 with that one shot, but is that going to be enough? T-side scaling out so fast now. BDA, he's able to collect that AWP on his low health. That Molly, that's a lot. Breezy, I think, fell asleep on that close angle. EXT doubles up. 4 versus 2, unlosable for the 4 versus 1. This is finally the round where IEPY is going to close it. EXT with the 2 entry kills. I think Breezy was just so focused on that van position that close peek caught him off guard.
BDA with 39, almost 40, in his first collegiate game of the season. CMX with a 35, Sherlock with 27. IEPY takes the map pick of DePaul, and now we'll be going to Vertigo. You did say that they lost their Vertigo game last time. I think with BDA, an actual side player who knows side, this could be a different story.
Yeah. I'm going to take a break in between maps. I will be back. come back with yogurt.
Just in time.
Got myself a yogurt snack to keep myself energized and nutrient filled.
This is literally what I was gonna call, but I'm...
Alright, see T-side here? I would assume a B-rush.
Well, Sherlock bought up a nade, so...
Okay.
Now, Def has seen nothing B. CT's the very aggressive ramp, now swinging. They're gonna see these players as they run up, if there's no flash, especially. This is gonna be an all-out deathmatch, which should favor the USPs. Yeah, here comes the flash from Straylock. Eventually. Well, it's gonna be a dry swing, actually. CMX goes down, CT's retreating. Except for Yif, who's on dual Berettas. He swings the 38! Finds one, and that's the bomb. Full spring, can't find a second. Scaling up to the bomb side is Gumbo, who finds a flank on the side player. Now 3v3, with bomb side under control. This is one of the harder bomb sides to play. Post plane in. Gumbo goes down. Oh, I got a flash. Gives EXT a little space to back up, but he himself is stuck on the bomb site. Finds one, but gets traded. Very winnable 1v2 for EXT here. But the CTs do have a kit. They do have a kit, though. EXT's now seen that there's no one on the bomb. That tap is going to make him reswing again. Def hits a nice, crisp headshot. And all off to a good start.
I'm shocked that like they were able to even get up and get the bomb plant down. I thought for sure default just had that unlocked, but that does mean that we'll see a force buy here. So Big Daddy 8, AK no armor. Okay.
He's just gonna instant HS them.
He has to. Or he's gonna give him a free AK.
Oh, he almost found Breezy there.
They know they bought.
Yeah, Def once again pretty aggressive on this B side angle. Cyclone, also known as Sack, on a small angle, that smoke gonna come in and smoke the entrance of Horseshoe. That was definitely a winnable fight on the T side. There was just no spacing close there. I don't know who was with Gumbo there. I guess it was Straylock. Spacing was a bit off on that swing. Def gonna work up close on this smoke. This is where you realize as a CT side that you're a bit outgunned. Your opponents have Galils, most of you have MP9. You start to get to those close angles. T side looks to, I think, pretty much just always late execute B with Straylock's utility. Actually, Straylock is mid, so maybe not. If he does clear the sandbags angle, that's gonna be Cyclone down mid. A player is now rotating away from the A bomb side completely, but that's not gonna matter as the T side are definitely gonna be here. Def close by EXT. He's not going to double up. BIA finds the trade. Now, Chris swinging from Jhin instantly killed. The pressure from mid is enough to force him to swing. Now, Breezy rushing in from mid. Both T side players very low on health, but it's a winnable round. All force onto BDA with no armor. Why is the first no shots taken? The no armor AK could be the win here. Spots out Yif. Oh, it was so close. He had at least three shots there to hit the headshot, but couldn't.
He had a chance. I'm eating my words a lot in these first two, but that was a good mid B split mid round there. Chris had his back. Chris was able to get kills on the flank there. Big DIDA was able to find two with no armor AK. We'll probably see a save here, I would assume.
I think if I was IG on the T side, I'd probably call a force by here.
You would call a force by here. I think they will save. To buy full.
I mean, look at the CT economy, man. They have more than I would expect. I guess it's because they got all those MP9 kills and not rifle kills. Looks like it's going to be a fast ramp scale from the T side. Yep. Not going to get blinded by that flashbang. And now he's holding a smoke and fog. This is going to be an absolute blowdown. Only EXT giving through. Lurk from Gumbo gets shut down. He was able to find one at B, though. And here comes the rest of the T side. That smoke is on time, but not going to be respected. See my swing in as suicide goes down. BDA misses the jump danger. Now Straylock first timing in. Goes down. BDA jumping. He gets the jump this time, but all that noise. He spotted. Pretty clean anti-eco from Alda. Alright, first gun round. If the AUG based, he's gonna move very fast into B. Very, very fast. It's gonna be a fast B play. He's gonna see the arm and hit the shot though. Seems he's getting away with the lives, but not with the bomb sights. It's gonna be a full 5-on-5 retake here. If the CTs know the right utility and can wait out the smoke, actually, this is not an easy bomb site. The nades tag the bomb planter all the way down to 6 HP. If they know a suicide molly in a close, in like a B main smoke, this could be a very easy round for the CTs to win. It doesn't look like they've got, they're lining up that molly, though. They might just charge through this smoke. Yiff gonna go down. DC only with 6 HP finds that kill. It is traded. But the crossfire being established, this is gonna be so hard. And here they come, through just going off the side of this. Skyscrapers, a disaster for DePaul.
That was a nice hold from APY, and a lack of any spacing or anything. They're just like CTs were all just bundled up and like.
Yeah, I'm actually shocked that like with how early they knew that was a B rush that none of like the mid players just went in flanks.
And the CT economy, it's gonna force a save here. If you like, could get a second round for free here to play it right.
The economy is like in a decent spot though, all things considered. Just excited. I think it's just gonna be a one save and none. Chris is so close, he finally is gonna go down. Rotations happening. The CT side very rapidly here. Very good utility from the T side to take this map control. And here comes the scaling on the site. BDA goes down. Yep finds one with the CZ. 2 versus 3 now. Oh! Yep finds one with the Deagle. It's 1 versus 2, and Zach is already on a flank. How ready is Sherlock going to be for a fast side flank? I think it's impossible for him to be ready. They're both got backs turned, but he can't find the second.
He had double backs turned. A very close eco round there for DePaul. They almost were able to win that. Probably could have. But IPY wins the round. And we'll be going back into another buy here. Breezy, though, or two FAMAS on the DePaul side. Full util, though, for the most part. And we'll see another B rush?
Yeah, I mean, Gumbo is going to be going for this pick. I mean, Def hasn't been going for that angle as much since the pistol and eco stopped. But Blake was right there ready for that peek if it came in. I think IEPY has basically just made the decision that the CTs are putting so much into ramp that they just would rather default towards B and mid. And I think that's a really good call. Def, is he going to be ready for this boost? It doesn't look like he's ready at all. Can't hit the flick shot. C-Max, very quick headshot as well. The mid lurk in the form of Straylock. The rest of the team now running towards B. Saxy's ready for this. Sherlock is just as ready though. Chris can only find one on his B side hold, and now I think you have to consider saving for the CT side. EXT should have a pretty simple hold here. Find the first, gets away, gets it up, and BDA will finalize that round in favor of the Jaguars, forcing the CTs onto a save. Last time we saw DePaul on this pretty much exact buy, they were able to make a make a pretty close round out of it. Gumboot with this AWP is gonna get ran at by about a million people, but CMX is there as an escort, and it is the fastest round of Counter-Strike you've ever seen. That was like all of like 12 seconds. So they get that over with incredibly quickly. That was in favor of the guy who said he had to play a Valorant match later. PDA has the, I guess, the B spawn, so he will be past the AWP. She's gonna take an A. The Gumboot's just not feeling it. I can respect that. Flash's side coming in, Flash's ramp coming in. This gets flashed off by IUQI's flashes, and this is an incredibly quick scale up the ramp for the Jaguars. Yip still in somewhat control of side. He's hiding in the smoke, and he's gonna get tagged down with the Tech Knight spray. Meanwhile, Breezy is only good for one, and this is where Chris is getting trapped. He's able to find the first kill. EXT gallery, the trade goes down! Chris super fast on that headshot. Sherlock finally sitting him down, but now finds himself in a 1v2. Stock sandbags. Fire on both sides. Not able to find the first. Can't flick to the second. 4-4. DePaul stops the bleeding and is looking to take control of the CT half. But they've got a big economy mountain to climb.
Yeah, that was good trading and positioning by DePaul. After initially IUPUI had the first push, DePaul was able to push back. Got a 4-4 game. It's the first time the CT's had an AWP. I think so.
Quick side smoke thrown by Strelok and some injury flashes as well. Chris not gonna get blind by those though. Wow, BBA is able to floor through. He's scaling upside. All the while, Chris sees pretty much nothing on ramp. I think he's very cognizant of the possibility of something up yellow. Gumboot presumably goes out on the B. Pick BBA trades the AWP. Maybe a bit over aggressive crane there. Breezy to the side goes down from CMX. This ramp aggression is just not working out for DePaul right now. They're gonna need another multi-frag from side. Sure, like it's caught in the mid lurk from the B player rotating. Now 3v3. Yip finds EXT. Here comes the trade onto site. Molly throws default. CMX training another kill on side. 1v3. Repositioning sandbags. CT's with plenty of flashes. I think they're content with letting CMX take some space. Yeah, jiggling for info. Wow, Sack just swings on that info. This is a crazy play for DePaul right now. I think they're finally readjusting.
Baba booey.
CMX still stuck. Finds an insta HS on the Sack and now just has to find Def. With 30 seconds left, he's going to opt for at least a fake reposition, but it looks like it's going to be a commit reposition.
Advanced
very quickly making this rotation. I think they're going to be pretty much equal timing here. And Def has the advantage to be able to walk. CMX, if Def doesn't show, I'm surprised he didn't make it to Gen. Bomb plant now coming in. Def hearing it, now walking up. CMX takes the swing. Def whiffing hard, but is able to clean it up. CMX goes down, and the clutch almost happened, but did not.
Wow, that was a great try from CMX, and a double whiff show there at the B-bomb site, but Def ends up... I guess he essentially just reset himself on that second swing. He just did a quick switch and is like, okay, I'm good now, and then we switched and killed. But yeah, IUPUI seem to take... are good at taking ramp initially, but then once they take ramp initially, it seems like DePaul is able to get the pushback on like those second swings on default and side.
Yeah.
After they kill the ramp players.
Weird ways to lose A side takes. It almost always feels like if you're gonna lose on the T side, it's with those ramp reaggressions on the CTs with flashes or with off angles, and instead it's the T side like just losing weird fights as they approach the bomb side.
Just walking into the crosshair essentially.
Yeah. Big A incredibly aggressive up ramp. He goes down for free pretty much. EXT not able to trade, flashed off the angle. And now once again a 5v4. We saw this last round, I think, after Gumboot went down on a B play. Meanwhile, Def is completely content with giving B stairs this round. And it should be noted the Sack is pushed into ladder mid. So if CMX walks through mid, this is not an easy angle to clear. This is not a spot you really see people push it all that often. He's gonna hear CMX drop off of mid. That should signal a B play. CMX is actually throwing utility. He's gonna see this util be thrown, and he's gonna kill CMX for free. I don't think I've ever seen that interaction ever. And CMX is salty in the chat about it. Gumboot now, he is his team's ticket to the round win, but he cannot find the entry. Def on an angle, and he just insta-HSs. 5 versus 2. Sherlock EXT left with it all to do. Chris and Def teaming up. Sherlock, it's so bad from Def's POV, but he's able to light up both, and Yiff closes it out. Hull into 6 rounds, and IEPY, their economy's a bit suspect here.
CMX upset.
Doing a bit of gamer raging in the chat. Standard ramp take, fast mid play from the Jaguars. That's the one at the cost of two. CMX gonna throw a mid smoke. Rizzy pushing in front. Death finds the kill on the BDA. Now a 2 versus 4. Horizon's IEPY. CMX gets shot in the head while jumping, and EXT finds the ball to do. Goes down through the smoke. IEPY is struggling to find answers here. This is 4 now in a row for DePaul on the CT side.
Yeah, DePaul is starting to build up a nice economy over on the CT side. Always nice to have. 4 in a row. See what IPY comes with. Ooh, attack timeout. Maybe a mental reset. Maybe CMX is not doing more than just typing and they need a quick reset. Or they're maybe they're saying, hey, we're taking ramp, but we're just walking and dying with no trades. So
yeah, I mean, I think it's a pretty the way the CTs are currently playing ramp are is the standard 3-person ramp take, where one person throws the ramp smoke and then throws a side flash and a ramp flash or 2 side flashes. The CTs take the initial space with that and then can hold and re-smoke from there. With that in your face, you can really do 2 things. You can try to like cheese some flash timings or create some chaos to take the ramp through those pieces of utility, which is kind of hard. Or you wait and you take it in the mid round. The examples that we've seen of IEPY taking it in that early round stage of the round, they've then tried to extend themselves on the A bomb site without throwing like wall of smokes or without throwing like side flashes. Or if they have done that, it's been an issue of spacing and timing, trying to trade out players that should be easily tradable. So I think just keeping it very fundamental with some kind of late round ramp take or a it's very good B execute will be strong enough. Because, I mean, we saw their first gun round B execute completely floored the CTs off that bomb site. So I wouldn't be surprised to see pretty much just any form of this straight fire, group and execute style play here. Good spacing mid, finally gets the kill onto a mid player. The trade comes in, you see not close enough to cover to trade that. Now forced off with a Molly. Def taking very weird fights on the B-bomb site and goes down. Now the B-bomb site under control of IEPY and BBA. He gets a second headshot. Chris able to trade Straylock, makes this retake at least thinkable. And with Breezy already on a flank, you've got to wonder how quickly IEPY will be ready for this. Breezy now walking up. CMX back turn generator. This is so strange. 2 backs turn. Breezy finds one. CMX is able to trade. That was a very close round. Closer than the player count at the end indicated. So, DePaul still in the lead. A round win here does extreme damage to the T-Slot economy. And with no op, I think this is a bit of a change from the CT setups we've seen kind of go on this run. But at the same time, I wouldn't be surprised to see DePaul able to clutch this out. Gumboot finds Sack, making a solo push into mid. That's going to damage the CT side structure immediately, and Gumboot finds that hole, takes the space, and is eventually mollied off, but with no mid-rotator, Def is just left on an island at B. Gumboot cuts off the mid rotations entirely for a moment. The T side isn't able to capitalize until Yiff, I think, flanks from A and goes down. So every push right now for Nepal is just going poorly. I think the T side is just trying to establish some kind of fake map control towards A. And then go back B. Actually, the bomb now. I think they just forgot the bomb at B. I'm just convinced that IE2, I just didn't even know what to do at that point, because now they're walking back B again. Def is playing an angle that is bad, but he's playing it because he doesn't know if his mid's clear and there's no one watching it for him, so any more than one kill here is just bad spacing by UI. Flashbang coming in. That should be free kill on the Def. Yep. So, this should be a very easy convert for the Jaguar. Breezy able to find one, but retaking with 15 HP is not going to be easy, and Chris is already in a save, so. DePaul looking to keep this half in, like, at least a contest for these last two rounds. Is he able to find that shot from CMX? Goes through a prop, I think, and only knocks him down to 8 from 15. Repositions up towards top spawn. Gumboot should be able to find a fight here on him. Sherlock goes down to Chris. And this money damage on the T side is actually relevant. Like, CMX, BDA, and Sherlock will all be buying down to pretty much zero. So, there's definitely something to be said about those kills.
Definitely, definitely. And the... Paul, though, gonna be forced to save outside of the two weapons. They are broke. We'll see where they put the two hero rifles.
I mean, those were both A players, and it looks like they're gonna keep them both A. CT,
yep.
The T side is running very fast ramp here. This is a definite fast ramp call. Maybe in reaction to the lack of economy on the CT side. Gumbo scaling upside. Two of his teammates scaling up towards ramp, and Breezy is in a very awkward spot to handle these fights. He finds Gumboot, the trade's not there. He gets away. So a good start. It's not a recoverable rifle, but it is a rifle down. Chris getting wallbanged down to 27. That's not going to be a fun sign for him. BDA knocking Breezy down low as well. And both sides going to be spotted out. Chris now has to push him to side. He gets punished. From now on, it should be a pretty easy cleanup for the IUI team. CMX finds Yiff from Twist's angle. And that's all she wrote for DePaul this round. Def with an all to do with a Desert Eagle. Flashbang goes deep. So, half comes down to just this final round.
Yep. Definitely does, all things considered. I think IUPI is okay with that. Regardless of how this run goes, I think they're happy with this Vertigo T side.
I think we can definitely say, after Mirage at least, their T side Mirage was significantly better than their CT side Mirage. So
yeah,
I don't know if that'll carry over to Vertigo, but I mean, this half has just been a half of runs. It was 3-4, 4-3. Could be 4 if everybody gets out, but BDA gets tagged on through the danger cardboard. 3 players going mid for IUPUI, and this is a bit of a different mid setup than we've seen from DePaul thus far. A lot of off angles that they've been playing have been more close to Horseshoe and the actual connector part. Sack's actually playing on the drywall stack here. Will get smoked off by the smoke if it's good, but it's kind of not. He might be able to get an angle. At the very least, he's going to be able to spot the cross over this smoke. Gumboot, I think he just barely snuck under. Now Yiff with all to do. Def with a back turn, and EXT doubles up. Yiff only on 1 HP. That flick is so quick. EXT going to get traded. But now a 3v3. Bombsite under control of IEPY. Gumboot's retreat almost caught out. Is a smoke and a flash on Sack, but they're not using it. Instead, they just double kill onto the bomb site. But now they whip out the smoke
thankfully for DePaul, they're able to trade that kill, but CMX just catching a good timing to peek almost cost DePaul that round.
Almost. But DePaul's able to trade. Breezy had a nice flank on the op, and Chris couldn't see, CMX couldn't see because of the smoke, which allowed him to get the free kill on the offer. 8-7 half, pretty normal, I'd say.
That is a bit of a redemption from Breezy's last B-site mid-site flank that he almost was able to solo win the round with backs turned, but just couldn't find the timing. That would make a key kill in that rotation. Open up that retake. So, DePaul onto the T side, buying up Smoke Flash Flash onto Breezy. He is going to likely display this smoke to the bomb side. Indeed, it's going to be a close generator smoke. With flashes likely to follow, the CT side have two players on this B bomb site. CMX playing the anchor position on the elbow. Gumboot is able to find one, sticks it out. CMX finds another, finds two for his troubles. There's no comms. They don't know he's elbow. And he gets four headshot kills. What a round from CMX.
I'm at a DM. Mm-hmm.
when the elbow lurk goes right, thing of beauty.
Yeah, everyone that died just didn't know they were getting killed from, I guess, because I mean CMX is shooting somebody who's basically pushed into CT spot. Kind of puzzling, really. I mean, I don't know where else they could have thought they were dying from, but well, I think CMX has got a 4K on pistol. He might get an ace on the eco. Never mind, I've jinxed him. He gets glocked.
Dude throws a one-way smoke with an M4 on a Glock round and only gets one.
Oh my god, the Glock dinks are in this round. Wait, what is... Oh, Yiff's just straight up AFK. He's back.
How does he only get one? He threw a one-way smoke.
I mean, he did a lot of damage.
No. That's an L round from CMX. CMX, bad round. L. All
right. T side, gun round. DePaul, down a round, down a map. Need this T side comeback to force Ancients, or they will be pushed into the 2-1 Swiss bracket and face it collegiate. 2023 spring version. Can they do it? It will hinge on these next few rounds and whether they can build up an economy. Early flash into B. Chris is going to be mullied off any push, but T-side ramp take very quick. The flashes are so good. The T-side is blind. BJNA whiffs, and Yiff finds the EXT. What started out as so promising, this ends in disaster. The one-way smoke, I think, missed a bit. EXT overswung past it. BDA whiffs his spray on blind players. And now a 5-3. On DePaul to throw this. I'm honestly a bit surprised that they're taking so long to plant this bomb. Oh, that was an insane flash from Straylock. He gets two with the MP9 on that play. Meanwhile, Gumboot's going through the smoke, trying to make space for his team. Gets shut down. That was an insane flash. Wow. Straylock onto the ace. But he gets shut down at the last moment. The flashbang to peek onto the A bomb site created a whole lot of space for him. He's able to find two kills, and in the chaos surrounding, he's able to find another two, but the AK-47 just too overwhelming on that last fight. And DePaul, they tie it up. CT, I think it was a bit of a miscommunication 3B, on the CT buy. There's actually a 3B call out of DePaul, but that's not true. There's only 2B. So I don't know if that misinformation was B, but maybe he meant 3 ramp, just miscalled. Anyway, IDPI has got themselves a decent start in this anti-eco. Fights all around the map. Lurking upside, Bomb definitely planning on going A here. This is not how the Pulse is playing this round out. Calling it up. Of course they smoke out of Big Daddy A and a reposition. That smoke lands a bit late for Yiff's life. Now 2v4 required on a hard bomb site to hold. However, all the CTs are coming from the same angle. They do not have to worry about the flank. Def is incubating the bomb. This could be good if he can multi-kill. He gets support from Ramp. He finds one, but can't find the second. Now Chris on 1 HP left with it all to do. Strelak looking through the smoke. Chris into it. EXT sticking this bomb. It gets shut down by Chris lurking around the smoke. The time playing so hard on Strelak's decision making right now. He pushes Ramp. He finds nothing. Rotating back to the bomb. There's no kit. IEPY has lost this round. On an insane lurk from Chris in the smoke.
1 HP. This is gonna be... Does face it show in these? It does, doesn't it?
Yeah, it should.
Yeah, that's gonna be a tilter. That's a 1 HP clutch. That was a great play from Chris to get 2 there. Or to get EXT and then run away like that.
Yeah. I mean, there were some very favorable timings as well as the fact that no one on IEPY decides to spray that smoke.
Yeah. Good eco round.
Wait, I'm actually so confused. EXT was holding side there, but they knew that there was one ramp. I guess he was just assuming that the rotation could have been made that fast.
I guess, yeah.
Either way, DePaul escapes from around another fast ramp play. That Molly's gonna force BDA out, but the flashbang finally comes in clutch for the IEPY ramp take. If DePaul doesn't adjust to that fast flash, they're gonna lose every ramp that they have. Now, there are gaps that flashbang, I think, to save BDA's life. Meanwhile, bomb headed towards B among all these fights. EXT goes down, gap on top of the smoke. BDA, he's lucky to be alive himself on 33 HP, runs away. Kumbu playing an off angle behind triple. These can be very strong if you catch them on the walk up. T-side definitely planning on a B execute here. Here comes the utility. CMX and Gumboot here to stop it. Gumboot able to find one. Not able to find a second. Now CMX behind the smoke and the mollies finds one. With a flashbang in his hand, Yiff whiffs enough for CMX to find that kill. And he triples up with the Gleal. An amazing round from CMX, aided by some mistakes from DePaul. But it forces IEPY onto 10-10. It's tied once again.
B site is closed. And the Teak economy is abysmal. They're going to be on a double here. They're going to force this one out. 1,500, 1,800 across the board. One scout on the Chris. No util. IPY, keep your heads up.
Looks like it's going to be 5 ramp for the T side here. If they go through the smoke again and not play anti-flash, they were anti-flash the first one. DEA still finding 2 before he traded. EXT finds 2 as well. This ramp play from DePaul has just not been successful since the first time I ran it. Wow. The no-scope finds EXT. But there's a lot more to do than to just find that first kill. CMX, very bored, is punished for it. If Chris can find this kill on a straight lock, this round becomes very interesting, but cannot. So, DePaul onto a save. IEPY, this is a chance to build up your bank and to really close out the game. Easier said than done. Looks pretty standard once again from the IEPY side. Looks like it's going to be a mid-fast play. From the T side, that nade does a lot of quality damage for CMX. He's gonna hear all these footsteps under connector. He gets one, he got two. Can't find the third. Now Gumboot under pressure is stuck fumbling with his weapons. And he goes down. Now the B bomb site, despite the low health bars, will be under DePaul's control and is a winnable round. Flashbang's coming in for the retake. Chris not panicking. Drilock will clear it. Jump around from BDA. Flashbang is super solid. Wait, that was a team flash. That was a team flash.
A3 from bottom stairs.
I was like, that's a crazy good flashback on that retake. I can't believe they threw that in the, you know, in the motion of all of that clearing, but it was actually his teammate that threw that flashback.
Yeah. All things considered for Black Brown Bomb Plant, the ball's gonna get a really good bite here. So this is when the
Yeah. I mean, I would not be surprised if DePaul, they didn't buy an AWP. I'm a little bit surprised by that. I wouldn't be surprised if they just kind of group up around ramp rather than rushing. They've been able to find kills on particularly EXT on this balcony, and Andy's been pushing down, BDA has been pushing down on the bottom side, and they've been able to find him through this one as well. So they slow down their ramp, like, they almost killed EXT there. He's on a 15 HP.
EXT already down to 15.
Andy flash into side again, nothing there, gonna retreat. Default still heavily towards this A-bomb site for the T-side.
Yep. They're gonna boost Big Daddy A and just kinda concede ramp, so... We'll probably see an A-XE if Chris doesn't find anything. And or even if he moves up. This looks like just an A-XE.
I mean, we're kinda seeing this mid-round play for a retake CT setup out of IEPY right now, so... It's definitely being offered, we'll say that much.
No. EXT is probably dead on a nade when they execute.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they do throw a nade up there. A lot of people are throwing
no right side smoke.
Yeah, I mean, he punishes it. EXT, despite the low health bar, is dodging all of these sprays with the smoke. And now the bomb is just now turning the corner up the ramp. BDA goes down. Trying to make a flash play through the smoke. EXT whipping a molly call out to try to molly the bomb plant. Goes out in the molly. And he's lucky to be alive. He's lucky no one's slowing him on that right side of the smoke. Now 4v4 post plant. No flank for the Jaguars. All coming from CT spawn. Breezy finds the first and the second. CMX trying to hold his teammate's side. Gumboot pushing onto the bomb site now. CMX up on top. Goes down with his teammate Gumboot simultaneously, and DePaul bounces back. This half has been back and forth.
Very back and forth half. Yeah, that was just a weird round there. IPI loses the initial ramp take. DePaul takes it, and then don't have four smokes. Only throw one right side smoke, and then just kind of swing up, which gets one on the team's kill. And then Big Daddy A tries to make a flash play through the smoke by himself, which gets himself killed, and essentially... puts them in a retake situation, and DePaul hits all their shots. I feel like forcing here is really weird.
Double nade mid knocks Def down to 2 HP, 3 HP. Fast scaling up the ramp from Yif. Isn't punished yet? Where's BDA in all of this? He goes down. I don't think they know Yif is up so far. Doesn't even matter. Everyone's dying. EXT able to find... Oh, that was CMX actually able to find one. But the A-bomb site is just under control, and the CTs, they have no money. I mean, getting killed from elevator, that is... They're just getting ran at, and it is working for DePaul. Breezy going for the ace, gets shut down at the last second. I mean, this is not completely out of the question, especially seeing as Def is on 3 HP. A bit of an ambitious play, albeit for the ace. I'm surprised Gumbu didn't pick up that AK. With no kit or smoke, though, this is not an easy retake. Cyclone offering himself up a bit. Running AK headshot from Death.
And this pre-firing, and then there's that. I mean, he had 3 HP. I don't understand why IEPY felt the need to buy there. They weren't in a position to double, like, I guess outside of one person, maybe? I didn't feel like they needed the force there, and they did. But nevertheless, they're forced to save again. Double flash... This might be.
I'm assuming Charlotte's gonna throw this stuff ramp. Yeah, indeed. EXT has just knifed the only player with armor on his team.
Knife the only guy with gun. Yeah.
Gumboot goes down. The flash is perfect. Once again, DePaul not adjusting to the flashbang, but the can only do so much. Pure chaos on the ramp. CMX hiding it on the B bot side. Charlotte finds one with the AK spray. Almost transferred to the second. That could have been round changing, but CMX is left at the very least with a chance.
And they're going to the site he's just leaving.
I mean, if he's Mega Brain, you kind of make the read that if they don't go A, you can just run at the ramp and get a gun. But at this point, you start to realize they're B, and you just have to, if you want a chance to win, you just have to go back to that bomb site without a gun. Plenty of utility for the T side here to set up, and indeed, there's another smoke. Death is to spot out CMX, trying to make a play on the defaults.
Bit of a lurk smoke thrown. That flashbang's gonna go behind him. Suicide! C-Max had a shot there. He's getting a head start on the stairs, guys. This is not winnable. Death only on 39 HP. C-Max, no armor, no kit. But Def is probably paranoid of getting pushed. The bomb tap will reveal CMX's location, but he pushes up. He misses the jump, jump, triple, swings out wide. Def,
oh,
incredibly lucky that CMX did not hit that headshot. DePaul ekes out a round victory on a save.
That was a very close, and DePaul ever wanted to be. CMX, I think if he hits that jump, he wins that round.
Yeah, I think that's correct.
Nevertheless, 13-12 now. Yif is.
I'm just shocked that Death didn't swing the trade after, like, there were, like, 8 Pizza 50 shots it took to kill that stairs guy, and Death is just hiding suicide the whole time.
Or, like, why they threw the lurk smoke and not just fought swung together, like, when he's fighting him default. Just seems weird.
Oh, I mean, things get tense when you're down a map, and it's 12-12, and you're losing an eco, so.
True, true. Ramp control once again gained by PY. DePaul, very keen on just playing retake. A ramp.
Yeah, well, I mean, they tried to take it last round, and
yeah,
did not work. I don't know if that lurk smoke was. I mean, it's okay. It covers Crane. I usually see deeper ones, but this one definitely seems like it's viable, and it could isolate BDA on this angle.
BDA ain't gonna look. Okay, no. Yeah, he's got him there.
That smoke gonna cover any sort of approach. BDA comes up. BDA explains the smoke. Hopefully, going for it, and BDA wins it. So, 5-2 all of a sudden for IEPY. Once again, kind of just highlighting the back and forth nature we've seen this half go. Neither team really seems to have a great kind of idea, a great game plan on how to beat the others. And a lot of these rounds are just coming down to the like scrappy fights towards the end, it seems. The CTs, every life that IEPY stays, like, basically retains here is very important. No, there's no save. There's no bank on the IEPY side, so every life matters. Yeah, I'm gonna get swung from an unclear suicide, and Rumble doubles up. From that angle, 13-13. DePaul onto a save.
IEPY in a poised position to take the 14th point. But these eco rounds by both teams have been very scary lately, so.
It's true. I think this one has a bit less teeth than the previous one. Except for Chris's bottom scout and armor. So he just forced into this, actually. Interesting. With pistols, I assume you just go up fast. They're going to go up fast again. Big Daddy A likely to farm. Indeed, he will. EXT gets one. I'm just so puzzled by these fast ramp takes by DePaul. Especially seeing that none of them really have, like, answered the problem of, like, this is no side lurk smoke. If you want to take ramp fast, you need a side lurk smoke, you can play Anzai, you need to punish the game. Chris finds a nice scout headshot on the BDA, but I mean, this is looking absolutely devastating for the DePaul economy and their chances to turn that happen. DXT with the swing, gonna clean up Greasy. I mean, Chris with a scout. Cyclone comes up with a deagle! But Chris can hit the shot of the Sherlock. The spray will finish him. And IEPY on a 14 and likely a 15. I mean, do you buy it?
And the money is really bad. Yeah, this is where you maybe tack call. Chris forces, so it looks like a force.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I can see DePaul basically just forfeiting ramp here to start and just hoping that IEPY like, give them some kills. It's a 1v1 mid setup, so if you're gonna find picks, this is what you want. That nade's gonna knock Breezy down a bit. Ramp completely under Jaguar control. EXT lurked up quite close. You don't see a whole lot of people do this anymore because of how easy it is to spray you back. Boost mid. Sherlock, if he jumps up, might get caught out. Indeed, he will. Able to live though. Now there's two people mid is the big problem for the T side. They might not account for this. Any swing that's wide is gonna get caught up. Oh my, C-Max gets instant HS by Death. And Gumboot goes down from stairs. Sherlock all alone on this B bomb site, which is inevitably going to be split. The T side stairs players come up before the mid players though, creating a tradable situation. Death into the CT gets shut down by BDA. 2-2. It's Sack and Chris versus BDA and EXT. Bomb site evacuated. Molly being thrown in suicide. VDA swinging Jin. Chris gonna miss that shot. The scout not able to find the kills. Sack playing the danger angle. That bomb smoke just missed. EXT goes down. Cyclone finds the headshot onto BDA. And DePaul ties it at 14. IUPUI's economy in the bin.
He's in the bin. So we'll see if they decide to force back here. Just a weird round all around. Big Daddy A has already bought pistol armor. I think for the most part, though, they're going to be saving.
That's just an Andy buy.
Yeah.
CMX also just made an Andy buy, though. Like, two players have basically hedged their bets, like, on, like, half buying both rounds, to be honest. So. Early B nade. It's going to be an early B fight. CMX wide swings and kills Chris, making a 5v4. These rounds make no sense. It feels like the worst economy has won every single round in these last five. CMX gonna spot out Yif, almost kills him as well with an MP9.
So this is a really good start for IUPUI.
It's just the B stairs default of nightmares for the Paul Blue Demons. Ramp, at the very least, is under control. EXC trying to find a left-right headshot. CT's with literally no utility. Sandbags
Big
Daddy
finding one. Wow.
Double quick headshot from Breezy. Up onto site, looking for a third. Last time he got these many headshots, he ran at his opponents all the way in the deep elevator. A little bit more restraint this round. CMX might just opt into saving this AK, especially
I don't think so. I think he's gonna go for it.
I mean, there's no kit, there's no smoke. I think you're supposed to save. BDA can't buy next round. Looks like they're gonna go for it, or at the very least pause and see if they can find something. That Molotov.
That Molly, she.
Yeah.
Didn't.
Oh, he missed it.
Still got him out. Didn't matter.
Tap comes in. Max finds the first, but I mean, this he bomb has 10 seconds on it, yeah. So.
DePaul finds 15.
That's at least overtime for DePaul. This game. Both maps have been so crazy. So, yeah, I mean, as we discussed, IUPUI economy, because of the half-buy nature of that round, I mean, Gumboot is going to be, if he has A4, literally, he's just going to have to buy the A4. He has A1S, so he's going to be able to buy a smoke at least. But, I mean, everyone, except for CMX and Andy, have reduced utility. T-side on full utility. Now, apparently, economy means nothing in this game thus far, but you've got to favor DePaul to, at the very least, force map 3 in this round. No early ramp commit. DePaul has learned from their mistakes ramp. They just refuse to full commit like they have been and just lose lives for no reason. IUPUI. It's a very familiar situation. Ramp control. The problem is, this round, they don't really have the utilities to sustain this control as long as they have in the past. So if DePaul can take the map control as light as they should be able to, after waiting a bit, should be in a pretty good position to close out this game. CMX on the anti-boost spot. Def just a bit off the backpack spotted. CMX takes the shots. 3 mid for the T side. I don't know if we've seen 3 mid as a default the entire half out of DePaul. This might catch IUPUI off guard. Sherlock tagged down to 74. The mid to B smoke thrown in. CMX, he shuts down against Ecos. He finds one. He can't find the second. Now Gumboot. And Straylock doubling up, swinging into stairs. Gumboot goes down. Fast rotation in from BDA. The bomb is down outside of connector. With 36 seconds left, you've got to favor the IUPUI Jaguars to force overtime here. But we've seen crazier things this game. BDA holding the pixel angle. He finds one, and he doubles up to force overtime.
More free Counter-Strike. Woo!
I mean, almost exactly the same scoreline we saw last game from the IUPUI side of things, where Chris and Andy are on top of everyone, both on 30 bombs of regulation.
This time though, 30 bombs in regulation. First 30 bombs didn't happen until overtime last game. They both got 30 bombs in regulation this game.
Prezi buying up AWP. Gonna take it towards ramp. I don't know how much we really saw the AWP going for picks. So, could be a bit dangerous for AEPY if they're not careful. Pretty quiet across the map. Danger boost coming in from DePaul. I don't know how much we saw of this either. Wow, Gumboot actually going for the danger wallbang there. Had it been just 5 seconds. Oh, the jump is missed. Did they hear that? Gumboot, ready for it. Can't find the kill. 4 HP. Chris trying to jump down without taking fall damage is able to do it. Meanwhile, Yif gets knocked down to 13 HP on a mid fight. A ramp player is still actively taking fights. It's really just a three front battle. Everyone taking fights across the map. Only a B player is killed. And ramp pretty much forfeited. Paul now taking the space very quietly. They have 3 smokes left, plenty to execute the A-bomb site with. Molotov coming in sandbags, no one to receive. Rotation now coming in from Yef mid. No lurks for DePaul, all committed towards A. EXC spotted outside, or should I say self-boost, the nade now flying in. Will that be enough? It will. EXC goes down 5 versus 3. DePaul finds BDA through the smoke as well. And now the CT is
just gonna save. Be forced to save, yeah.
That was systematic.
Yeah, systematic by DePaul.
I mean, a pretty, all things considered, a pretty insane mid-round sequence there with the danger boost coming into play, yeah, a mid-fight coming into play, and a ramp fights with 2 versus 2 essentially on a ramp all happening simultaneously. For all to just kind of reset and go into an A execute was very well disciplined from the DePaul side.
Definitely.
Looks like UF is going to get the CT off, but since we get some hard life, the CTs are able to find both players. Able to find CMX. Stay alive lives. And you don't need much to keep your CT economy intact with 12,500, especially because IAPI didn't buy any ops round one. 16-15 to Paul, looking for an overtime victory, forcing map 3 and ruining everyone's sleep schedule. Quick smoke, put out CT Molly on the stairs. Very standard ramp take once again. I mean, this, it's a very similar situation that we saw last round. 2 bottom ramp for the T side, 1 lurking mid for the T side, 2 bottom B for the T side. IPI is kind of give up ramp here very quickly. Except maybe BDA is just kind of switching spots. There's an op. That smoke is very shallow. That's not deep enough to, I think, keep T's out of ramp, or at least the information that they could gain. Freezing going for pot shots and wallbangs. Molotovs, I think, are about to be thrown on this B bomb site. Everything's setting up and suggesting a B execute. Here comes the smokes. Molly being thrown suicide, Molly being thrown elbow. Gumboot stuck, smoking himself just to survive. How long will it matter? That flash might blind his teammates. He's going to be found through the smoke. 5 versus 4, site taken. Boost being had. CMX finds 1, finds 2. Death push up so close. Wallbangs have spraying. They're so close, but no kills happen. CMX going through the smoke, finds a kill. It's pure chaos. Yif on the flank finds only 1. Now Chris 1 versus 2. Both players so low, he should just pistol, but he's still opping. He doesn't know. All the IEPY players are pistoling. They win the post plant. What?
Chaos on the B-bomb site. CMX able to find 4. A nice boost after the B site comes in. Molly's raining, sprays go wild. CMX and Big Daddy both spray their M41s and are stuck to pistols. No calm from teammates that they're both could be low for the operative pistol himself, and wild round that IPY is happy that they're the victims of, for sure.
I'm so stunned. That round is a perfect encapsulation of, I guess, the scorecard, because CMX and BDA are the only one that gets kills.
Yeah.
I just want a chaotic retake. Is this finally? It's a fast ramp once again from DePaul. It's been a while since we've seen this. EXT bails out. BDA pushing outside, finds the first. He's very good at this aggressive play. No one's really looking back at him. EXT is able to find one. And because of the smoke still ramp, Breezy's just running past, gets killed. BDA doubles up. I mean, just once again showing IAPY is just like basically just like having full mastery of this ramp in this match.
BDA and CMX, army of two. Deciding that they just want to beat the Paul basically by themselves the way they're playing. Although that round EXT able to find one, Big Daddy A finds three.
I mean, so often I've seen Big Daddy A just able to find the first kill side, and instead of like backing up, he'll push forward and he just catches people off guard with how aggressive he is in that position. A lot of people will either back up towards Henny or back up on the A bonsai. Big Daddy A just runs at them. Looks like we're going to see a B-Rush here, and this is a fantastic call, as it is a 4A stack. It is a 4A stack for DePaul. Def is solo on this B-bomb site. They're not respecting that smoke. This is a lost bomb site. 5 versus 5 retake incoming. Now, the mistake I thought DePaul made last time was all 5 rotated from 15, and again, there is no flank. There's no B-stairs flank on this retake. They're all just going to group up around these smoked-off angles. This is going to get mollied and naded and sprayed, and this retake is going to have to all happen so quickly.
EXT just swings. No reason to...
Yumbu trying to trade goes down as well. Sherlock finds two, though. BDA running through smoke finds one, finds two, and CMX finds the third. Good double from Sherlock. Very chaotic retake, but it looked like DePaul might have a chance there. So IUPI on two series points here to close it out. Two overtime maps, but it might still be a 2-0. Fast B play.
CMX did what Andy couldn't last game and has dropped 40. Big Daddy A could get three. He's going to go for the B pick here. He just switched him off to go for the B pick here. We'll see if anyone even goes to challenge
him.
Looks
like Def's riding for it. Oh, he's just going to ball in.
Oh, he's still going to swing, but...
Wow, the flash doesn't catch him! And BDA finds it.
Flash doesn't catch him. Well.
Breezy almost had a fighting gun boot there. It's so uncommon to see an upper mid like this that... Yeah, Gumbo's gonna back out, though. Throw some spots to keep him wrestling. Meanwhile, an A default being set up that Molly will stop the ramp progression, but only briefly. Lurksmokes being thrown on site. This is the series for DePaul.
Oh my god. Big Daddy almost killed him, the side player. Acting the 1 HP through wall bangs.
Yeah. Lurk from Sack does not work out. 3 versus 5 for the series now. All 50s are here.
I feel like Snake could find a kill. He just gives it a good toss.
A bit of a gap here. That smoke's gonna erase it though. That Molly forces Breezy out of any viable smoke kill spot. That nade will tag EXT down a mid, but not enough to stop a bomb plants. DePaul needs an absolute miracle. That's a start. That's another good kill. 3 versus 3 now. They have a smoke on Yif. If he deploys this onto the bomb, we could see... He smoke side instead of the bomb. He smoke side instead of the bomb. Now they just have to fight ramp. Yif not able to find a kill, but a collateral! Now Breezy just has to hit one shot. He can't do it. Now Chris on special HP is swinging, and he goes down. CMX clutches the 1 versus 2.
Oh my god, dude.
Oh my god. Every round was so chaotic towards the end.
They almost had the miracle, too. Holy.
CMX saving them at the end.
CMX and B-Daddy.
I can't believe he smoked science on the bomb.
Your two star players showing up both maps. That was just... Sweet. That's IPY's. Those are IPY's fraggers, and they got the job done. IPY takes a convincing 2-0 and a 3-0 to start the basically season.
What a 2-0. 2-0 but close.
Very close. Very close.
Let's see. 3-0 bracket right now includes 7 teams. RIT, CMU, Drexel, Davenport, IUPUI, MSU, and UT Austin. All of those teams, I think, are going to be teams that IUPUI are not going to sleep on for sure. So mm-hmm. next week's game is going to be a good one for sure.
How many games are still, or how many potential games are there still?
There are a lot of teams at 2-1.
There's only 3 games left of the season. Okay. Or left of this week.
Yeah. So, I mean, very close maps, both maps. It really felt like either team was going to win. I really felt like either team could have had both maps. Especially Vertigo, it seemed like DePaul had chances to win multiple times and let them slip. But at the end of the day, IUPUI comes out with a victory. And we'll probably see them. They typically start the schedule on Friday or Monday. So if I stream, it'll be either Friday or Monday next week.
Oh, yeah.
Try to avoid weekend games. But I'll end the stream there. Thanks for watching.